Extreme, as I said at the beginning of the show, we're going to see a little simple chemistry. We're going to see the difference between blood and water coming up at Hog Wild. No doubt about it.
You think so?
I got no doubt in my mind.
Well, I have no doubt either in my mind, only on pay-per-view Hog Wild. You know, tonight on the mothership, we will really focus in on these things that happened and interviews and listen to guys that were involved in that situation. And this young man right here, Alex Wright, talked to him before we went on the air this morning. Very, very, I mean, here's a young man that hadn't been here long at WCW, but he's ready to fight.
Oh, yeah.
He's saying, hey, man, this got to cease and not exist no more. And so I really believe, as I said, brother, we can, and Mark Stahl too, but they know they got to stay focused for this match, how important it is right here at WCW with the big boys play the number one wrestling organization ever in the world right here. We're looking at WCW.
Amen. Amen to that.
Thank you.
Alex Wright, Mark Stahl, two young men that both equally need a big, big win this morning on the Pro. We talked about how Das Wunderkind's home folks back in Germany, they keep very close track with Mark Stahl. They will find out about the results of this match probably by this afternoon.
Yeah, they keep close track of the Wunderkind. Mm-hmm. And they know Mark Stahl is an up-and-comer and is really looking for a victory. And it would be an upset. And it would upset the German population, I guarantee. Oh, got him with a...
Yeah, he got him with that elevated spin wheel
and
kick.
And that elevated spin kick means that
he left his feet.
Yes, he's not standing both feet on the ground.
That's correct.
I guarantee you that.
Both feet
on the ground.
He had both feet in the air.
Well, right here, Alex Wright, I mean, if we are winding up now, the giant, I mean, I can't wait to... I hadn't been able to talk to him this morning personally, one-on-one, to find out his mindset. I know he is ready for this thing. Hollywood Hulk Hogan.
Yeah, really.
Hall and Nash, if you will. They will be hauling and gnashing right out of Hog Wild, I guarantee you, when WCW get there. Only on pay-per-view. WCW TNT Monday Nitro, a hottest show on television coming up this Monday live.
Right, that's right.
What happened this past Nitro? What we'll talk about tonight on Saturday night. All these things so important right here at WCW right now. As Lee, Stegley, as you said, hostile takeover. I believe...
One, two...
We got to turn it around now.
You're going to see what happened on Nitro right here on the Pro.
You kicked me in the knee so many times, I'm going to get mad and hit you back. And that's what's got to happen.
I understand it. Ooh! Advantage now. Mark Stahl, he can put Das Wunderkind away. Right hand, right forearm. You got your fat boy ready there, Dream?
He's sitting right beside me.
Size suplex. Stahl could go for the win, too. Ooh, Das Wunderkind able to kick out. Stahl again, the lateral press again.
That one,
Alex Wright.
That one, you didn't even see that. You made that go right over your head.
That went over my head.
I got my soft tail ready.
I know you got... You know, some things are just better left unsaid.
You got him peeing.
Look at this. Two. Yeah, I got my Harley in the shop.
You're speaking of Harley and everything. We know that situation with all of us and everything, but even Medusa involved in this, because she's with a big girls play at WCW.
Yeah. Bull Nakana.
Yeah. At Bull Nakana, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
A battle. Battle of the box are going to transpire.
Now, what does that mean exactly?
That means exactly that I believe Medusa, I know she'll be driving her Harley.
Yeah, that pink Harley, yeah.
And Bull Nakana will be driving some type of Oriental machine. I ain't gonna slander no name.
All right.
But,
ooh, look at that. One, two, that's it.
That's a good one right there. But the end of that thing, going back to Medusa real quick, and Bull Nakana, the end of that thing, the winner, is going to go ahead and just, if you say trash, the other person back, and I hope it ain't that Harley. I know it won't be. You know what I'm talking about?
I know what you're talking about. Yeah, Medusa's got that big pink Harley, that Milwaukee steel against Bull Nakana's Japanese-made motorcycle. The winner of the match gets to, basically, as you said, trash the other one. Take a look at this, Dust.
Right here for the flying head scissor. Got him up. Right here, back suplex, knife bridge. Won the kid on the way to the pay window. Come on, WCW. Come on, Giant.
Yeah, everybody rooting for the Giant as we head into Hog Wild. Make sure you call your cable operator. Make sure you are a part of Hog Wild. We're coming back with more Pro. Not only number one on the track, number one in the great sport of professional wrestling, and where the motorsports meets up with wrestling, surges South Dakota. Hog Wild, we will be out there with our soft tails, brother.
I guarantee
you. Some of us fat boys.
I guarantee you one. What did you say?
Those with sportsters are also invited.
Oh. I tell you what, Disco Inferno out here, concern running rapid. I want to go back and address a fact real quick right here before this match with him and Billy Kidman get underway, because it's going to be a good one on the pro this morning on TBS.
Yes.
Fact here, people say, well, this past Monday Nitro, Sting, Nature Boy Ric Flair, same ambulance.
You is know that what I mean? Dot Richardson?
Listen to me, same ambulance, okay? Mm-hmm. Right? Going down the road together. Well, sometimes things happen that brings, that are so devastating, that brings all of America and everything together.
Yep.
An example, the tragedy, if you will, at the Olympics.
Yep.
Okay? In that situation. But America and the world at peace was brought together.
That's right.
So in this scale, which is a lot smaller than that tragedy, but in this scale, as we speak here at WCW with the New World Order, I believe now then, stand up on our hind quarters and let's go to fight. Is that plain enough?
That is exactly plain enough. It was, in fact, the NWO, the New World Order, his Hulk Hogan's plan to somehow cause dissension within the ranks of the WCW.
Well, he done it.
It totally backfired, pal.
No, he didn't cause the... I mean, you're right. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt you. He had dissension, if that was it, to call Winona Judd.
Was that Winona?
To call dissension. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
Well, it's brought everybody together.
You're right.
And is that what you were saying?
That's exactly what I was saying.
Is that what dissension means?
Yes. Yeah, you've heard dissension in the ranks?
Yes.
Well, that's what that means. But we don't have any at WCW. If they wanted to cause dissension, if they wanted to create bad feelings, bad blood, if they wanted to cause insecurity within WCW, it has not worked.
So what you've seen, let me analyze this. We get ready for this pay-per-view at Hall Wild and Sturgis.
Analyze
and only
it.
Can buy this thing on pay-per-view. These two guys right here, Billy Kidman and Disco Inferno. Both of them desperately need a win on TBS this morning. Both of them want to win. They have trained their life, young life so far, to get a win here, to move up the ladder on WCW. But are you saying now then they could honestly be, I'm just asking you, stand together side by side? Let's say in the next second, if the outsiders came out here.
Right? I think they would.
Yeah, well, that's what I think.
I think they would. Matter of fact, I know they would.
There you go.
You know, to punctuate that point, we're going to see Sting and Ric Flair. I mean, I don't know if they were so consumed with the activities and the actions around them, but all of a sudden, they were thrown together in the same ambulance. Normally, they'd like to send each other away in a different ambulance.
Yeah, nice move right there by the Disco Inferno to cut Billy Kidman off. He knows, Disco Inferno knows, that he's got to keep Billy Kidman grounded.
That's
you
exactly
keep him grounded,
right.
Because this young man is so close to scoring a major victory each week in and week out here at WCW. And he's focused on what he has to do.
Going to say, you talk about somebody who is his own worst enemy. That really explains Disco Inferno. He is a good wrestler. He has the skills.
Yeah, he's good. A good wrestler. Yep. Yeah.
But then he'll start posturing. Look at that. He's posturing now. My hair. Yeah. Look at me. I'm dancing. Ah, not slick. No, you're not slick, pal. Referee tells Disco to get off Billy Kidman's hair, but he's doing what you suggested, Dusty. He has got to keep Kidman grounded.
Yeah, and if Kidman makes a mistake, okay, then he has to capitalize on it.
Watch this!
Like, whoa! Well, out of my mouth as I live and breathe.
Mm.
But no peeing, only...
He's choking him!
Yeah, speaking of choke slam.
I hope to see it.
I made the analogy that the giant was a young man with a lot of ability and is carrying our standard bearer. You know what I mean?
He is
carrying the flag for us. The leader of the pack. Is he ready? I talked to him. He heard these comments and confronted me about this, and I like that.
Good.
I like confrontation. Yep. He said to me, he said, are you telling me because Hulk Hogan has been World Heavyweight Champion and Hulk Hogan has been on all the major events in the world that I might not be ready for him? I say, listen, big man, I ain't trying to get into your mess, kid, here.
Right.
You know what I mean?
I know what you mean.
What I'm saying is there is so much important here at stake, and I'm going to ask you again. And I looked up at him about 5 feet in the air, and I said, listen, are you ready for this guy? He said, brother, you expect choke slamming city
is going
on.
I'm glad to hear it.
Yes. Going with it.
I'm glad to hear it.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
I'm glad to hear it. If this man is going to come to Sturgis, he has got to have his game face on.
He does.
And if he assured you, then I am satisfied.
Yeah.
I don't care how many times Hulk Hogan was heavyweight champion of the world, and I'm not discounting that at all. The fact is that right now, as we speak, right here on the Pro TBS, what champion is the giant?
No, this kid is injured.
That's it.
Yeah, oh, man.
Not since Greg Louganis hit his head on a dive. That's the worst mistake I've ever seen. Disco might win this one in spite of himself on that big mistake by Billy Kidman.
Boy,
one, two, three, that's it.
Well, he got him a victory, and he capitalized on what we were talking about. A big mistake by Billy Kidman.
Yep.
Got a victory here for the Disco Inferno. Wow, what a miss.
I'm telling you.
That's what happens. Stagger Lee,
yeah.
That's what happens when you try maneuvers like that and you miss it. But that one, I believe, hurt his lower back, lower part, and he's lucky to be walking out of here.
Yeah.
Will the outside of the New World Order be walking away from pay-per-view at Sturgis, South Dakota on Hog Wild?
Well, all they've got to do is face the biggest athlete in the world and the most crushing slam, the choke slam. You join us for Hog Wild. We're going to show you more coming up on WCW.
Good morning and attention hotline fans. The wrestling world is anxiously awaiting with great anticipation to find out who this new man is who allegedly is going to be joining the New World Order. There was a rumor of an eyewitnessing of this man, this fourth man, joining Nash Hall, the chairman of the board, Hollywood Hogan. Very little known about him at this juncture. However, I have been doing my research. I received a telephone call after Nitro this past week. Where did that call come from? It came from a good source. I am going to share all of that confidential information with you today, all day long, on the hotline. So give me a call today, 1-900-909-9900. Call right now.
Now, if you're wondering what happened inside that ambulance, I mean, under what you would consider normal situation, you have Ric Flair and Sting holding a baseball bat locked within the confines of an ambulance. You'd think that, well, something was going to break loose, but all they were was concerned about Marcus Alexander Bagwell and with Arn Anderson. Psychosis making his way into the arena. He's going to be taking on the former U.S. heavyweight champion. That, of course, Conan. Conan still retaining the Mexican heavyweight championship. You'd like to see these guys in the Plaza del Torres, I know. One of the great arenas of the world. You're seeing them right here this morning on TBS on the Pro. That's Psychosis. A young man really has made his mark. He's getting a lot of international attention right here at WCW, where the big boys play.
You know, the matchup that, going back to having a thought process here, while you were talking about Psychosis, great athlete that he is, and also Conan, former United States champion, currently the Mexican heavyweight champion, and the matchup in the international flavor it has. But going back and thinking about what it's like, and I know on occasions, I mean, I've been carried from the ring with broken bones and broken ankles, that Sting and Flair had no obvious other thought except their friendship and the caring for their fallen comrade. But knowing that maybe I would have liked to see, with a secret camera in there, maybe an eye-to-eye contact, and to look to where they maybe looked at each other and say, man, we got to stop mess and get on with it.
I
believe that this has happened. I think we're all turning around looking at each other. At first, we said, well, the outsiders come in. They almost hurt Eric Bischoff. I mean, hurt him. I mean, seriously injured him.
Yeah.
What I mean. Almost seriously injured him, right?
Yeah.
And then Hulk Hogan turned his back on everything that is right or wrong. That he had preached for all them years, right? And then there were four guys. We only seen three of them. We wonder where the other one's coming from. And me personally, that old fighter mentality, that old cowboy, let's go to the bar and get it on mentality, because I'm too old to change, has been wanting to do that. I see now that maybe, I don't say we took them lightly when they came here. Obviously we did not. But what I'm seeing right now is Hog Wild is going to be the proving ground, I think, for the new WCW to really crank it up with the big boys play and make a statement to them. Mm. So they threw all the blows.
Oh, they have.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, they, but a lot of those blows were thrown with, as you said, Eric through a table. Baseball bats on Arn Anderson.
A matchup face to face.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you, you can break a table.
Yeah.
You can break bones, as you said.
Yeah.
But you think they've broken the spirit of WCW?
No.
I do not think so.
And not to take away, you know, I got a letter from some fan about Psychosis and some match last week where we didn't talk a lot about it. Well, the important thing, statement-wise right now, if you're listening out there, fans, is that what's going on in WCW and what's happening with the New World Order This match is very important to both these men. They are great athletes. They are fly. They use a lot of holds that I don't know about because I never used a lot of holds. But the bottom line is that either one of these guys right now, if you said, hey, we got to fight out here and the New World Order is here, they would probably leave the ring and run out there. I would hope they would.
You can bet they would.
That's what we're trying to say this morning on TBS on the Pro. If, man, it's time for all this. Nice move right here up top. That was an arm drag.
Tremendous.
Leapfrog.
Look at this. Wow. We're going to get to see in Hog Wild, you talk about the outsiders and the two that we really know of, Hall and Nash. We're going to see them take on Lex Luger, the total package, and Sting. That's coming up at Hog Wild, and we'll see whose spirit gets broken then.
Exactly.
Like the broken table, well, broken bow, yeah, that doesn't matter. Yeah.
Sting and Luger got to step to the plate also. We all do. We're talking Giant and Hogan, but that is the matchup, too. That's where it's all started.
That's right.
With Sting and Luger and Hall and Nash and the outsiders. They are the one that brought this thing to the forefront, if you will. Now they're taking out paid advertisements.
Oh, yeah, what's that all about?
And, well, it's a free country, you know what I mean? But bottom line is we don't have to like it. You see right there a near pin, if you will, by Psychosis. As I said, I don't believe anybody really has the ability of this young man, except Rey Mysterio Jr., of flying and going with a high-risk maneuver, if that's what you like. You know what I mean?
Yep.
But brawling-wise, I don't know really how tough he is, but I know how tough Conan is, and he can get it done with his fists, too.
You know who impressed me with his toughness? Rey Mysterio Jr.
Oh,
they took him and like, I think it was Tony who mentioned they threw him like a lawn dart.
Step over a domino stretch, a lot of pressure.
They stretched more than a fat lady's girdle. Look at that.
A what?
Stretched more than a fat lady's girdle.
That is
girdle.
So that, weak.
Don't you?
That is weak.
Don't you go there? That is very descriptive.
That's two weak ones. Oh, nice backhand chop right here. Flips over. Clothesline. Hung him up.
And he stumbled a little bit, and you saw why.
The impact.
Yeah, but he's got that patch over his eye. That takes all his depth perception away. And that courtesy of woman, by the way, for those of you who didn't see that some weeks ago, when Ric Flair defeated Conan, it was mostly due to a high heel into the left eye of Conan.
What do you figure he's doing right now? What's he trying to do to him right now? Besides slap the snot out of him.
I think he's just trying to serve a message to him that if anybody is going to be the next in line for the U.S. title against Flair, it's going to be Conan. But first of all, Flair's got to get by Eddie Guerrero at Sturgis.
He flying-mared him right off the top. Mm. Very simple. Going up into a power bomb.
This he's setting him up.
Yeah.
Oh, he got him.
Yeah, I told you about
one,
Conan.
One, two, three. Conan needed that win. That puts him right back into the hunt for the gold. You know, speaking about gold, Green.
What?
You know, I come from L.A. and Hogan from Venice Beach, and there are a couple of jewelers there, the well-known Mike and Nick, and Hogan has already put his order in to change the inscription on the WCW belt to NWO. He wants that belt, and that's the first thing he's doing. It is taking it to the jeweler and have that gold reconfigured to say NWO. The replay brought to you by Pep Boys, your automotive superstore.
Well, you got it right there with a clothesline up high right here in this Pep Boy Power Pin of the Week right here on the Pro this morning.
On TBS with more on Hog Wild. By the way, we talked about this earlier on in the show. With all of the calls we have received, I do want to reassure those of you that have called, Hog Wild will be available only on pay-per-view 1 week from tonight, live from the Black Hills, next Saturday, August 10th at 8 Eastern Time. I don't know, was it Jack Parr who said, I kid you not? Yes, I kid you not. WCW Heavyweight Champion The Giant has accepted the challenge of Hollywood Hulk Hogan. Hogan, a member of this much-talked-about Sub Rosa, the New World Order. The other members, Hall and Nash, the Outsiders, will collide with our own total package, Lex Luger, and his partner, Sting. It was and is becoming all-out war. In other action, WCW Tag Team Champions Harlem Heat, with Sister Sherry and Colonel Robert Parker, will defend against the Steiner Brothers, Rick and Scott. United States Champ Ric Flair meets the brilliant Eddie Guerrero. Lots in women's competition. Medusa riding a brand new Harley meets Japan's Bull Nakano. Yes, she is going to be riding a well-known Japanese motorcycle. And get this, Whoever wins the match gets to trash the other's fight. Plus, Chris Benoit will lock up with Dean Malenko. Cruiserweight title holder Rey Mysterio Jr. defends against the Ultimo Dragon. And in singles action, Ice Train to meet Scott Norton. You know, as I sit back, I can't recall so much interest in any one event as the interest that has been expressed for Hog Wild. It's brand new from World Championship Wrestling, and again, I emphasize it is available only on pay-per-view. 1 week from tonight, don't delay. Call your cable company or satellite dish owners. Contact Turner Premier or DirecTV. I guarantee you this is going to be one for the record books. We're 1 week out next Saturday, August 10th, 8 o'clock Eastern Time, Hog Wild.
We are a week away from what is not only going to be a most historic pay-per-view event, but probably the most important pay-per-view event in the history of WCW. Make your plans right now. In fact, right now, pick up the phone, call your cable operator, tell them you want to be online, hooked up for Hog Wild from Sturgis, South Dakota.
Yeah, you better call somebody because this is going to be a big one. Right here, you see Chives coming out with the Blue Bloods. I know they focus is tag team action, and they focus this morning is beating the Steiner Brothers right here in the importance of that situation before we going in to Hog Wild.
Yep.
WCW Saturday night, so much to talk about tonight. The Silver Tongue, Tony Schiavone, if you will. And bottom line action will go on there, and then always the most watched program on television prime time, Monday's TNT Nitro, 2 hours
yep.
live this Monday. We seen so much this past Nitro.
Mm-hmm.
I can't imagine what we're going to be seeing
right.
Monday night.
You want to join us for all 2 hours of TNT Monday Nitro. Starts at 8 o'clock on the East Coast. That's 5 o'clock on the left side of the country. And it goes until 10 o'clock.
There they are.
Time. 2 hours, the most exciting, as you said, the most exciting show in primetime television, TNT Monday Nitro. And those guys there, Eric and Larry and Tony, they'll keep you up to date on what's coming up as far as Sturgis and the pay-per-view Hog Wild. Call your cable company now. It's going to be the Steiner Brothers. They'll be at Hog Wild. In fact, if they get this win, they're going in with a great deal of momentum. They'll be challenging Harlem Heat for the Tag Team Championship of the World at Sturgis. But the Blue Bloods, you're going to know they're looking to make a message this morning.
You made a good point about momentum, and that's what we need right now. Everybody needs a little momentum.
Mm-hmm.
When you be down some, you need a momentum to come back and to really crank it up, and I think that's what we all need.
We're about ready for the bell. We're coming back right after this.
This portion of WCW Pro Wrestling is brought to you by Pep Boys. 26,000 items at a guaranteed low price. Tires and service, too. Everything but gas.
Here we go. This is our main event this morning on TBS on WCW Pro. Rick and Scott, the Steiner Brothers. There you see the Squire Dave Taylor and his lordship Stephen Regal. I was going to say the one person you don't see is Robert Eaton, the Earl of Eaton.
Well, they've had some problems communicating, I believe, in that camp right there. Now, lost Stephen Regal and Squire David Taylor, they need to ground the Steiner. Steiner's got more speed and more power and more meanness, I believe, to where the Blue Bloods possess a great amount of mat skill,
yes,
mat knowledge, taking you down, weighing you down. They need to get him in a corner over there, I'm talking about Blue Bloods, and cut off the ring on him. And so far, their offensive game plan has not really taken off and left flight.
You talk about guys with a lot of power, and that brings up one of the matches coming up at Sturgis. Ice Train and Scott Norton. You talk about two powerful men. They don't come any more powerful than that. These two men, side by side, shoulder to shoulder for so long, we thought that they were as powerful a tag team as the Steiners. Well, all of a sudden, Scott Norton left Ice Train, and I mean literally left him in the middle of the ring, and he was defeated by the Steiner Brothers. And
well,
now it's going to be Ice Train and Norton settling the score
at
Sturgis.
That's being focused there at Sturgis at Hog Wild. You need to get on the telephone, and this pay-per-view is ready to be bought. I guarantee you, this will really be... And the New World Order, they say, New World, NWO,
yeah,
whatever
yeah.
that is, they will provide more people coming. So at Hog Wild, the outside, and then the word on the street is there is people from the outside.
Yes.
Are coming in, and who will show up at Hog Wild? Who will show up tonight on Saturday night,
mm-hmm.
much less live on TNT, WCW Nitro, TNT Monday Nitro Prime Time's most precious commodity right now is TNT Monday Nitro
And it's going to be live 2 hours, yeah. Which it always is on Monday night. And the Saturday night show, the mothership, of course. And here we are in the morning. Always a pleasure to shoot this thing off and get it going right. Yep. Got him cut off now. That's what they needed to do.
We start things off here every Saturday morning on WCW Pro into the mothership. WCW Saturday night. Sunday is the main event. Monday, as Dusty said, the most exciting 2 hours in all of television. That's TNT Monday Nitro. You're going to want to see all 2 hours of it as we lead into Hog Wild exclusively on pay-per-view. As far as who is the other outsider, I'd mentioned a big fan of yours, Dusty, our flight attendant, Granada. I got into a conversation with her, and pretty soon the entire airplane is wondering who is the next outsider. And all we can speculate is that it is somebody from the outside. Nice. Down goes Taylor. Regal's on the outside.
Yeah, Steiner's cleaned the ring right there in the blue blood. Whoa! Baddest dog in the pound. Now need to regroup just a little bit. Ultimate Dragon, Rey Mysterio Jr. coming up, Cruiserweight title match. We talking only on pay-per-view. Get a phone, buy that thing at Hog Wild in Sturgis, South Dakota, Harlem Heat, the Steiner Brothers, Eddie Guerrero, Nature Boy, Ric Flair. Talking world, United States heavyweight title. But Hall and Nash, they started off.
Hall and what?
Hall and Nash.
Hall and Nash,
they would
be
Hall and Nash down the highway.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Hall and Nash.
Yes, yes.
Down the highway, right? Because Sting and Luger, this thing all started there. And I really, looking on the face of Sting in that ambulance.
Yeah. Frightening.
Man, I'm telling you, it's
time. I'll tell you another thing
that was frightening. We got to get up on our hind feet and go far.
I think the people that joined us this morning here on the Pro and saw what happened on Nitro and saw Rey Mysterio Jr. head first thrown into the side of the building, you got to wonder if Rey Jr. is going to be ready to accept the challenge of the Ultimate Dragon at Hog Wild. I think he is.
I think we'll all be ready.
I said earlier, you know, you can break bones, you can break boards, you can break tables, but you cannot break the spirit of WCW, especially a courageous fighter like Rey Mysterio Jr. Well, you took one right in the schnoz. Squire Dave Taylor took one right on the beak, and here comes Steiner. Wow. Rick Steiner, right hand, and it lays Taylor out. One, two. Rick Steiner again on Squire Dave Taylor. Nice hip lock by Taylor. He's pushing Steiner down, going for the pin. If he gets the ladder, he's got him for the lateral press. Kick out by Steiner is the USA chant. We hear it all over the Disney MGM studio. Right here on TBS, WCW, Saturday morning for the Pro.
Well, you see, now being at this point of time when they've been unsuccessful, I'm talking about the Blue Blood,
yeah.
They have to change. Well, they just did change the way they go about this victory if they're going to get a victory right here this morning on the Pro on TBS. Tonight on Saturday night, the Silver Tongue, Tony Schiavone and the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, looking at everything new. From what I'm hearing, there has been some new accusations made and things said. And tonight on Saturday night, we will talk about I can't tell you this.
You have breaking news tonight?
I got breaking news.
All right.
I got breaking news.
6 o'clock, WCW Saturday night, 3 o'clock on the left coast. Tony Schiavone, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. That'll be Saturday night.
On the left coast.
The left coast. That's what we call it.
Who called it that?
Those of us from the left coast.
Ow! Well,
His Lordship, Stephen Regal, he's dealing left forearms on Scotty Steiner. And I've got to wonder at this point if the Steiners are looking beyond the Blue Bloods and thinking about Hog Wild and their matchup for the titles against Harlem Heat.
Well, in some cases, you might say that to where you're talking about maybe other athletes and other sports. But in wrestling, you know that daily or nightly, you're challenged by somebody. And I think their focus right here is they know the Blue Blood.
Mm-hmm.
They don't have to look at no tapes about them. They've been in there with them.
Yeah.
So they know they cannot afford a loss. And the Blue Bloods know they need a win real bad. And that's what makes for great competition right here this morning on the Pro on TBS.
Dogs out of the house.
Yes.
Rick Steiner slamming Squire Dave Taylor. Now he's going after his lordship, Stephen Regal.
He's a wailing on him, too. Got him stopped right there. Now maybe trying to put him away.
Taylor goes for the clothesline and misses. Oh my word! What a suplex! What a slam by Rick Steiner. One, two, and now Scott Steiner.
There's the
Earl of Eaton. We were wondering where Bobby Eaton was. There's the Earl. This could be it indeed.
He hit his own guy.
Oh man!
Boy, that ain't gonna sit well now. Gotta cover him, Rick.
One, two, three, that's it. Well, you thought there was dissension among the Blue Bloods before.
They really gonna be now.
Eaton, this guy has in so much trouble. This guy's been in more jams than Smuckers with this team. Bobby Eaton cannot get anything right as far as Dave Taylor and Steven Regal. I'm telling you, these guys are flying apart.
Well, I tell you what, you see the discussion right now, but talking about, I guarantee you, don't turn your dial, just stay with us all day, because WCW Saturday Night, the mothership tonight, more about Hog Wild, the biggest pay-per-view in the history of WCW.
Join us tonight, WCW Saturday Night, and join us next week for The Pro. We're going to have great action coming up for you. And don't forget, call your cable company right now. Call your cable operator. Tell them you want Hog Wild. For the American Dream, I'm Lee Marshall on The Pro. Saturday morning, everybody. Lee Marshall and the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes on TBS for WCW Pro, and we are all revved up with some place to go.
Well, I tell you what, we have got the airplanes are lined up and the bags are packed. I have been out there through that area, and I guarantee you, everybody is talking about Hog Wild. I've seen more motorcycles. I've seen more good-looking women. I have seen some big hollies coming down that highway, and I know Sturgis is gearing up. Lee Marshall, Stagger Lee, Hog Wild, the giant, is not intimidated by Hulk Hogan, is not intimidated by the New World Order. And I guarantee you, everybody is tense and on edge as we go into this big pay-per-view tonight. And you know, Saturday night, they'll come in live hours from Sturgis for you. Plug it in to pay-per-view.
You're going to see more action on this one particular Saturday, beginning right here on The Pro on TBS as Kurosawa gets ready to walk through the ring. Saturday night, tonight on TBS. Then, you call your cable operator right now. Make sure you tell them you want to be online. You need to be connected. You need your television sidecar hooked up to Hog Wild as we come to you exclusively on pay-per-view. Making his way into the ring to meet the challenge of Kurosawa, here he comes, Heyo Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan, Kurosawa, great amateur that he was. Big, strong guy. Two big, strong guys here. Not a pretty picture will it paint.
No.
I guarantee you on this squared circle, because there will be fists of flying. Hacksaw Jim Duggan coming in. Man, I guarantee you, when you take a look back this past Nitro, as we get ready to go into Sturgis here this evening and then going on in tonight for this pay-per-view and this WCW Saturday Night coming up live, and I guarantee it will be in Sturgis. One thing is for sure, limousines, flowers can be sent, notes can be dropped. We stood on our hindquarters and said, come on, was ready to fight this past Nitro. Nobody seems to be intimidated. The bottom line now, the wall lines have been drawn, is Sturgis, South Dakota, and it is tonight, and it's getting ready just in a few minutes. I know everybody is a-gearing for Hog Wild.
We're going to open things up on The Pro this morning. Hacksaw Jim Duggan, Kurosawa, as you said, Dusty, this is not going to be necessarily a wrestling clinic. Although Kurosawa, former member of the Japanese Olympic team, and again, congratulations to Billy Payne and everybody involved in the Olympics, the tremendous 1996 Olympics in Atlanta. And Hacksaw Jim Duggan, not necessarily an Olympian, but I tell you, he can show you something that maybe a lot of wrestlers don't have, and that's the brute force to do whatever he wants to with an opponent.
Well, and just like they said, the people of Atlanta want a gold medal with that Olympics, and I agree with them. But here at TBS, WCW, where the big boys play, we have won a gold medal standing up to the New World Order, if you will. And Hog Wild, only on pay-per-view, to coming up tonight. Later on tonight will be the event of a lifetime. The giant. Love to see him in this mode. As big as y'all, you can carry a big stick. And I guarantee you one thing, he is not intimidated, doesn't seem to be. And I'm looking forward to that matchup right here. You see these two big guys, they ain't intimidated by each other either.
You're going to see some big guys on Hog Wild, as you said, Dusty. The giant, the heavyweight champion of the world. He defends the WCW title against Hollywood Hulk Hogan. Make that Hulk Keanu Hogan, whatever he wants to call himself.
And I tell you another thing on the line right there, too. Hall and Nash, if you will, outside of that started this whole thing. and Sting and Luger preparing for this situation, going in and just busting in and taking off that tape. I love that. I love that on this past Nitro. And that matchup there, I think, is going to set the tone of what happens the next day. We all are looking for Hog Wild Night on pay-per-view. And Saturday night, the mothership coming live from Sturgis, South Dakota.
We will be in Sturgis, South Dakota. Myself, the American Dream, Tony Schiavone, Bobby the Brain, Heenan. We're all going to be there. It's going to take all of us to bring in the action.
Mean Gene.
I'd say Eric Bischoff, but nobody saw Eric last TNT Monday Nitro. We're going to presume that he's going to be there. Into the corner goes Duggan, and down he goes.
Yeah, he went down Kurosawa now, maybe taking an opportunity when he got the big man down. Don't want to get in Hacksaw Jim Duggan's fist. You know what I mean?
Yes.
You get in range of one of them big pals, and he busts you and busts you good.
Now Kurosawa with the assault by those kicks, picking him up for the slam. Got him. Now Kurosawa thinks he's got Duggan in a compromising position. He's going to go for the pin right here. Kurosawa taking up to the elevator, going up to the top floor, and here he goes. Oh, but Duggan catches him in the midsection. Good move by Duggan. A double axe to the back of the head. Duggan going to respond with a slam. He got him. Look at this. Wait a minute.
No, but
Duggan go. He's got the tape, Dusty.
He's taping him big old paws
taping
up right now.
That fist. Oh! That's it. That is it. I don't care how tough Kurosawa is, and he is. I mean, to begin with, Duggan's got a hand like a catcher's mitt without the tape on it. He wraps that tape around his hand. It's like getting hit with a canned ham. There's your winner, Hacksaw Jim Duggan. As we go into Hog Wild, fans, we cannot make this more clear. The only way you can see Hog Wild is on pay-per-view. Now, they're not going to show you the clips of it on the 11 o'clock news. You're not going to see the still photos in the newspaper. To be online, you need to get online. Call your cable company right now. Tell them you want to be part of the action. From Sturgis, South Dakota, hook up your sidecar. Get on to your fat boy. We're going to Sturgis for Hog Wild.
All right, here, Hacksaw Jim Duggan goes ahead and goes Hog Wild on Kurosawa. Gets the 1-2-3 right here with a big mud play.
Big win for Jim Duggan on the Hog Wild Weekend. We'll be back with more WCW Pro on TBS.
I'm going to call your cable operator, tell them you want to be put online for Hog Wild exclusively on pay-per-view. Dream, I know you just came back from Sturgis. In fact, you've been there since Wednesday. What's the atmosphere there?
Well, it's ribbed up.
So.
You know, ribbed up Hog Wild. Motorcycles everywhere. And there are some lovely ladies running around with skippy motorcycle outfits on. But me be a madman. Oh, hush, hush. Do not look. Bottom line, Hog Wild pay-per-view. Getting ready to leave. Air Force One, I think, is waiting outside a helicopter. Someone's going to drop me right back down there in Rapid City. South Dakota moving on into Sturgis here. Just a little while this season on the Pro. Going to talk extensively about it this morning. Came back just to be with you out there. My mama's going to be watching. Already plugged it in. Hog Wild Day. Celebration going on in Houston, Texas. Get ready for Hog Wild tonight.
Why do you get to take a helicopter? Me and Tony Schiavone in Oakland have to take a rented DeSoto to Rapid City to go to Sturgis. I don't get it, Dream.
I am the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. That's why nobody crack whip with me. Let's go on now to the Pro.
Dusty, I have a distinct feeling when we come wheeling into Sturgis, we're going to see Los Tres Hermanos. I mean, Mondo, Hector, and Chavo Guerrero to watch their younger brother, Eddie Guerrero. This is the day that he has been waiting his entire life for, and that is to challenge the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, for the U.S. Heavyweight Championship. Eddie Guerrero, he's going to be taking on Manny Fernandez, and then, like us, hitting the road as we go to Sturgis.
Well, Eddie Guerrero's got his work cut out for him, I guarantee you that much. When we talk about the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, Manny Fernandez in there with a man possessed, a man that has a mission, if you will, at Hog Wild tonight. Don't forget about Saturday night, 2 hours right here on TBS, preceding Hog Wild only on pay-per-view. Nature Boy, Ric Flair, Eddie Guerrero, Hall and Nash, Sting and Luger, the outsiders that started this whole thing with the NWO, the Giant, Hogan. I guarantee you, don't want to miss this one, baby.
Nice switch by Manny Fernandez. Takedown by Guerrero into a scissors kick out by Manny Fernandez. Dusty, we've talked about not only the excitement, but this could well be the most important weekend in WCW history. We begin it right here on The Pro. Later tonight, Saturday night, Ben going to Sturgis live, Hog Wild, available on pay-per-view. Then the main event Sunday. Then Monday, TNT Nitro. What a great weekend to be a wrestling fan.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, here at WCW, where the big boys play has been laying it out. You know, one thing is for sure, this past Monday Nitro, WCW stood up on the hind legs and started to fight fire with fire.
Yeah.
That's what needed to be done from the get-go, just like young Eddie Guerrero right here. Manny Fernandez, not a pushover by any means.
No.
But I guarantee you, when you're on a mission like Eddie Guerrero is, when you have destiny in your hand, when it's knocking on your door, that's when you take advantage of. We're talking about Hog Wild on pay-per-view. Sturgis, South Dakota, Stagger Lee.
Yeah.
What an event that will be tonight. I can't wait. The plane is wrapped up and I'm ready to go.
We are all revved up and we've got someplace to go. Now, where you need to go is over to the phone right now. Call your cable operator. It is not too late. Still time. Call them and tell them you want to see Hog Wild live. Available only on pay-per-view. Among the matches, Eddie Guerrero and Ric Flair for the U.S. Heavyweight Championship. The Giant and Hollywood Keanu Hulk Hogan. For the whole thing, the big enchilada. The heavyweight championship of the world. Hall and Nash are going to take on Sting and Lex Luger in a match that I'm really excited about seeing is the match between Medusa and Bull Nakata.
No.
That's going to be a match in which the winner gets to literally trash the loser's motorcycle. And you know Medusa's going to come in there with some of that Milwaukee steel, if you know what I'm talking about.
I tell you what, the Dragon 2, Rey Mysterio Jr., yep, hooking it up. The list is endless. And so many surprises coming on the live portion of WCW Saturday Night, the mothership preceding Hog Wild on pay-per-view. Manny Fernandez right
there.
Look
at this! Two!
Got a big bridge. I'll tell you what, sometimes you're thinking about a big match. I know Eddie prepares for every match, but you can't make a mistake right now, this late.
That's right.
This late, when opportunity is a knocking on the door of one young Eddie Guerrero.
Your El Paso homeboy laying the right hands into Manny Fernandez. And as far as Eddie Guerrero, this isn't any match. This is the match. An opportunity to face the nature boy, Ric Flair. Fernandez, he takes it shoulder first. Guerrero's going to hook him up. A brain buster.
Yeah, laid it in there real nice too. Get him in a situation. Come on, Eddie, put him away. It's time to go to Sturgis, South Dakota. It's time to go Hog Wild. The NWO, the WCW with a big one.
When Guerrero hits you with that frog splash, that's it. There's your winner. A man who feels his destiny is to become the U.S. champion, Eddie Guerrero, in just a matter of hours. Eddie Guerrero laces up the boots, buckles his chin strap, and goes after the nature boy, Ric Flair. We're going to have another look at the way this one happened, Dusty. It's brought to you by 1-800-COLLECT. The way to call and save on collect calls, dial 1-800-COLLECT from any phone to any phone and save.
Yes, sir. Frog splash off the top. Eddie Guerrero on the way to the pay window, on the way to Sturgis, South Dakota.
Boom, boom. We're coming at you. Hook them up, baby. Coming at you with more pro right here on TBS. We have seen Nature Boy Ric Flair intense in the past, Dusty, but now he is wound up tighter than a cheap watch.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, the Nature Boy Ric Flair, I think WCW as a whole with the big boys plays. If you want some of it, come on and get it. Going to get the opportunity tonight, a few hours away,
yeah.
Sturgis, South Dakota.
Look at that.
Yeah. Yeah, the Squad 8 Taylor don't take too kindly to chimes there, and I guarantee you that's been roughed up. Roughing him up is called the whole bunch of dissension in the ranks of the Blue Blood. But back on pay-per-view Hog Wild, back on the mothership. We're talking WCW Saturday night.
Tonight.
We are going to kick it off. We talk so much about it. The matchup, the Flair, the Eddie Guerrero opportunity knocking.
Yeah.
Hall and Ash, the outsider that started this whole situation of this hostile takeover, the NWO. Hulk Hogan turning his back on America. The Giant surely now has to step to the forefront. If you know what I'm talking about, Stagger Lee, and meet this thing coming full force at him tonight at Hog Wild on pay-per-view.
Dusty, I know you've had a chance to talk to the Giant personally, talk to him about the intensity, the fire, putting on the game face, what it takes to walk into the squared circle and defend the title. Not only the pride that goes along with that title, but the pride of the entire WCW rides on this man's colossal shoulders.
You know what? Some of the young guys that I'm talking about, the younger men, it's hard to sit around and listen to the old wall stories about wrestling and pro wrestling and what it's all been about, where WCW really stemmed from and how it came about.
Right.
And they sit around and the stories sound good. But I guarantee you, this is where they got to stand up, take some pride here in the company, if you will, and get on with their business at hand. And that means all of them. Still, you have opportunities, too, like the gambler right here against Squire David Taylor on this morning right here on TBS to get a victory. And all these things are in part right in the midst of all this. There are inner fights going on, as we know, with the Blue Bloods.
Yes.
There are inner fights going on with the Four Horsemen. So, man, tonight we're putting all that aside.
Oh, yeah.
The New World Order. WCW, where the big boys play.
Yep.
Pay-per-view television. And first off, though, WCW Saturday night coming live from Sturgis, South Dakota.
Look at Taylor. So pompous. But there is trouble in his house. As you said, there's trouble in the Four Horsemen's house. I'm not so sure to buy off on the fact that everything's hunky-dory between Chris Benoit and Woman. We know things are not straight between Taylor, Regal, and the Duke of Earl, Robert.
I'll tell you something about Dean Malenko and the Chris Benoit situation.
Oh, what
Dean
a neck breaker.
Dean Malenko should never allowed himself to get involved with Jimmy Hart. Mm-hmm. We're talking about that stake in the grass. But what he's wanting, as what we all know,
right,
is the cruiserweight heavyweight title. We know that. We understand that. But I guarantee you there's more to that than meet the eye. Woman really comes into play there.
Yeah.
But where will women come into play tonight? Where will Elizabeth come into play tonight? Deborah, devilish women, all of them. Still all.
That's right.
But make no mistake about it. WCW now standing up on his hind quarters. See, there's a fight going on, and I want in the middle of it, and that's what it's all about.
European uppercut by Dave Taylor, another by Dave Taylor. By the way, pick up a copy of the new WCW magazine, a tremendous article on this man, Squire Dave Taylor, the fact that he is indeed a third-generation wrestler and goes into the ring as the former United Kingdom heavyweight champion. This man has got all the qualifications. He's got a resume, I'm telling you.
Yeah, and he's dominated this contest right here with the gambler who has looked good
in
his outings lately. Right there, got a slam.
One, two, three, that's it.
Got him hooked up right here. Squire Dave Taylor gets a win on the pro this morning on TBS as we get towards Hog Wild.
Squire Dave Taylor hitting the gambler with that Hail Britannia over the top suplex. And that was it. There's your winner, Squire Dave Taylor, as we head into Hog Wild. Call your cable operator now. Tell them you want to get hooked up. We will join you from Sturgis, and we're coming back on the pro.
Good morning, everybody. As you know, Hog Wild tonight in Sturgis, South Dakota, and wow, you talk about the rumor mill churning about the possibility of some new entrants into World Championship Wrestling. Well, I haven't been hanging around, actually, the wrestling crowd, but I've been sniffing around some rather, well, off the road, off the beaten path places, and you're going to be surprised at who I've seen over the past couple of days out in the Black Hills. Could these men that I have seen be joining the New World Order? Because it's pure speculation, I can't talk about it on the air, but I will tell all today, all day long on the hotline at 1-900-909-9900. Hotline coverage starting tonight at 6 for the big event. Don't miss it. On TBS with more on Hog Wild. We talked about it earlier on in the show. With all of the calls we receive, I want to reassure those of you that have called, Hog Wild is available tonight exclusively on pay-per-view. We're going to be live from the Black Hills. It starts at 8 o'clock. Make that all-important call right now. Seems like everybody's trying to run the company these days. As you know, WCW heavyweight champion the Giant, with Jimmy Hart the Giant accepting the challenge of Hollywood Hulk Hogan. Hogan, a member of this much-talked-about new organization called the New World Order, NWO. Other members, Hall and Nash, the Outsiders, will collide with the total package Lex Luger and his partner Sting. This is war, believe you me, after the last couple of weeks. In other action, WCW Tag Team Champions Harlem Heat with Sister Sherry and Colonel Parker defend against the Steiner Brothers, Rick and Scott. United States Champion Ric Flair meets the brilliant, the electrifying Eddie Guerrero. Plus in women's competition, Medusa with her brand new Harley meeting Japan's Bull Nakano. She is going to be riding a well-known Japanese motorcycle. Get this, whoever wins the match gets to trash the other's bike. Chris Benoit to lock up with Dean Malenko. Cruiserweight title holder Rey Mysterio defends against the Ultimate Dragon. And one-on-one, they have split Ice Train to meet his former tag team partner, Scott Norton. We here at TBS are getting ready for Hog Wild. So much interest in this particular spectacular, brand new from World Championship Wrestling. And again, I emphasize, it's available only on pay-per-view. Folks, it happens tonight, so don't delay. Call your cable company right now. Satellite dish owners, contact Turner Premier or DirecTV. This is going to be one for the record books. It happens tonight, live from the Black Hills at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. And, of course, 5 out of the West Coast. Cinch them up. Tonight, it's Hog Wild.
You got to know that Wildcat Willie is going to be at Hog Wild, probably driving there on his moped. And we are just hours away from the most important wrestling event, certainly in WCW history, Hog Wild. This man is going to be in action, Dean Malenko. And I don't envy him, because later tonight, he's got to take on Chris Benoit. But coming up right here on the Pro, he's going to try to get what he thinks is his, and that is Rey Mysterio Jr. in that Cruiserweight Championship of the whole world, the Iceman,
well,
Dean Malenko.
It's a real treat this morning to have Rey Mysterio Jr. right here against the Iceman, Dean Malenko, in a matchup that a lot of people wanted to see, and we got it for you right here on the Pro on TBS. On top of all these things we have talked about, dwelled on, the NWO, WCW with the big boys play, Eric Bischoff missing in action.
Yeah, what's that
Flowers
all about?
Flowers delivered, notes been delivered.
Briefcases.
I mean, yeah, one thing is for sure, it might not, I know for a fact it's 4, it could be 5. Tonight we'll find out if there's any more outsiders in the NWO coming to Sturgis, South Dakota. We see the man walking to the ring, Rey Mysterio Jr., electrifying wrestler.
Let me tell you something, Dusty. One of my last remembrances of Rey Mysterio Jr. was that TNT Monday Nitro, after he just had been laid out by one of the outsiders. He was laying on his back. Eddie Guerrero came up to him, and Rey said, Eddie, there were 4 of them. Man, I'm telling you, there were 4 of them. Then we heard, at least from our pal in East L.A., Joe Sanchez, he had some information on 85. We're coming back with the match. Here we go. Get out your notebooks. You can call this La Escuela de los Luchadores, loosely translated. Maybe this is going to be a clinic for wrestlers. You're going to see every kind of move. Dean Malenko, a man of 1,000 holds, and the Cruiserweight Champion, Rey Mysterio Jr. Rey Mysterio. I know you call him Rey Mysterio. Rey Mysterio Jr., and already Malenko serving notice on Mysterio. He doesn't want to stay in there too long with him. He'd like to get this thing taken care of very quickly, Dusty.
Well, he's been very aggressive, and we know Rey Mysterio Jr. is the smaller of the two men. But I guarantee you, he's the type of guy come back and bite you like a snake right away. And Malenko knows that. He's been in there with it. He's got to ground him, you know what I mean?
Exactly.
You got to keep Junior grounded. If you don't, he will really snap at you quick. And that's what he's trying to do. And I guarantee you, this is one of the most aggressive starts that I have seen Malenko really take on this thing. But you see, Rey, he don't take no fun. As an up leapfrog, small leapfrog, up on
watch
top.
Watch Mysterio for the pin, 1. No, Malenko able to kick out. You're absolutely right, Dusty. Rey Mysterio Jr., he'll give you every move of an aerial assault. As far as Dean Malenko, he'll come from you at every side. So the best way to go after Mysterio is keep him grounded. Going into a knuckle lock, a finger lace. This might not work to Mysterio's advantage. Well, it has. As you'd mentioned, he was not the biggest man in the ring. But he put him into an armbar, into a drop toe hold by Malenko, and now riding time for Malenko on Rey Mysterio Jr.
Yeah, cross-faced him right there, got him down, got that legged hook. Hog Wild, only on pay-per-view. The Giant, no intimidation. He says, Hulk Hogan, you do not intimidate me. Ric Flair says, you guys come and get it if you want it. You beat up my friend, I beat up your friend. We take a look at Hall and Nash, who started this whole outsider incident. You take a look at the missing Eric Bischoff on this past Monday Nitro. The intrigue is set. Sting and Luger
getting ready to face the match of a lifetime at Sturgis, South Dakota. Hog Wild, only on pay-per-view. Buy that thing right
away. It is, too.
And one other thing, too, is there might be big surprises on WCW Saturday Night to Mothership tonight, coming live on TBS. But right here this morning, what a matchup. And Dean Malenko, all offense, breaking him down. Got that arm barred up there and that leg over the other side. A lot of pressure put on that arm and that shoulder and almost them ribs.
Almost a seated abdominal stretch. Referee asked Mysterio who wants to give it up. Ray Jr. says no. But at the same time, he's screaming. Malenko is really cranking it on here, Dream. One of the many holds, one of the thousand holds you'll see Dean Malenko apply in the course of any match. Rey Mysterio Jr. able to get over to the ropes, able to break the hold. Malenko setting him up. Could be a pile driver. No, look at this. A pinning move by Mysterio. He's got Malenko. Malenko reverses. Two. Kick out at two. Left forearm by Malenko.
That wasn't pretty, but it was effective. And he drove him right back in the corner there. And as I said, you know, for Rey Mysterio Jr. to come out on top of this situation, wow, break that arm down.
He's got to
use some of his speed and his ability to crack and pop from the outside coming from the top rope. As long as Dean Malenko keeps Rey Mysterio Jr. down right here, the Cruiserweight Heavyweight title will belong to him this morning on the probe. Chris Benoit waits in the wings, and that feud, woman involved.
Yes.
I mean, that feud is a raging right here.
A version of a camel clutch now by Dean Malenko.
He's got that hind end of his riding real low, and boy, you can see how he's got him jerked up right there. That'll really put a hurting on you.
Well, look at it very simply. The spine isn't supposed to bend that way.
And Dean Malenko did a good job of coming in with this game plan of grounding him.
Yes.
And that's what he's doing. And right now, if you was on a point system, Dean Malenko to just be ragtagging.
Oh, yeah.
But you can't count out Junior. Oh, got him high up. Just gotta hurt. That's it. Could have him pinned right here.
Lateral pin, two, kick out.
Wow, how'd he do that?
I have no idea.
How did he do that?
You talk about intestinal fortitude by Rey Mysterio Jr., able to kick out of that. And Rey Mysterio Jr., he had something happen to him during that incident during the Monday Nitro where his mask was taken off. When you take the mask off a Mexican wrestler, that's like, you know, taking a parachute away from somebody and then telling them to jump.
Right here, you got a surfboard situation on him right here. So much pressure. He has applied Dean Malenko that went to the neck, as you said, from that injury. Has used that portion to get that back down. Not good enough cover. Knew that one. Kicking the head.
Yep.
Very aggressive. Dean Malenko this morning on the pro.
Malenko has got a reason to think that Mysterio's neck is injured. Don't forget, it was one of the outsiders that hurled him into the side of a building like a lawn dart. And yes. Malenko's been concentrating on Mysterio's neck ever since the bell rang here, Dusty.
Where will the next outsider come from? The New World Order tonight on Saturday night. Will they wait until pay-per-view? Will they wait until Hog Wild after Saturday night? So much at stake at Sturgis, South Dakota. As we head that way, not long from now, the planes are revving up and the bikes are everywhere. And there's people all over. Harleys are ready to go. For Sturgis, only on pay-per-view. And as you said many occasions, pick that phone up. My mama already picked that thing up. Done called me this morning. Say, I already ordered it. I got it.
We haven't said hi to your mom.
Yeah, say hello, mama. She's watching us this morning.
Good luck.
There you go.
We are so excited about Hog Wild. Both these men are going to be in action in just a matter of hours. But I'm wondering right now if they're going to get beyond each other this morning on the Pro on TBS. Malenko and Rey Mysterio. Mysterio into the ropes. Sleeper by Malenko. And look at this combination. An abdominal scissor and a sleeper.
Well, that's a no-win situation right there for Junior. What he needs to do now is try to forget about the abdominal for a minute and try to get out of this sleeper, cutting off the carotid artery, if you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, you're talking about the carotid artery.
Yeah, and cutting that thing off. He needs to get out of this situation right here to where he can handle. You got to handle one thing in at a time. And with Dean Malenko, he can put you in three holds. You don't even know you're in them, and then weigh you down.
Yeah, and the other thing you got to be thinking of is if he's putting two of them on me now, he's got 998 left to show me.
There you go.
The thing about Malenko is being in that position, I don't really think the sleeper's going to be effective because he can't lean over Mysterio and put his weight on him.
Yeah, but what he's done is grounded him. Let's go back to that. We talked from the get-go. Everybody talks about the aerial moves of Rey Mysterio Jr., but I tell you what, Jr. has not got off the ground. He has not taken that thing in flight. And in tune to that, Dean Malenko now has a wearing him down to maybe he won't be able to do what he does best, Steggily.
He's got that abdominal scissors on him, cutting off his wind, putting the sleeper on him, and I don't care if it's 100% infected, he's cutting off the blood supply into the brain. He's attacking both sections of this man's body. You talk about a game plan, he's attacked the upper and lower body of Rey Mysterio Jr. And I wonder at this point if Rey's got enough left in him to say uncle.
Well, I guarantee you one thing, Junior really can take a lot of punishment. Obviously, he's had to, always been in there most of the time with a bigger man. Always had to use his speed and ability and agility and ways to get out of this thing. Ooh. Oh, frustrated Dean Malenko broke the hole.
Now, that's something you don't see very often is Dean Malenko getting frustrated. One of the reasons we call him the Iceman is because he is so cool. Say, this man's so cool, he's cold.
Well,
he's ice.
Let's see what he does right here. See if he goes back to it.
Oh!
Still working on that back. He's in no danger right now.
One, two, kick out by Mysterio.
I'm talking about Dean Malenko. He's in no danger.
He's in total control at this point, in my opinion. Like you said, Dream, if this were the Olympics in the wrestling, Malenko would be outpointing Mysterio severely at this point. He has done what you had mentioned. He has kept Rey Mysterio Jr. grounded. Snapmare, once again. He puts that on him again. Combination, abdominal scissors and sleeper hold.
Well, that was a good move for him to go right back to it. Well, I'll tell you what. Oh, the excitement. I can just feel it. I can smell it. I've been out there, as I told you.
Yeah.
I've been out there, and I can feel it, man. And the fumes are just a-burning. And there's a lot of bad blood running in the air with WCW and the New World Order. So good to see Sting and Luger going in to shut that thing down on this past Monday Nitro.
Yep.
But I tell you what, they got to shut down Hall and Nash tonight at pay-per-view when they meet in this colossal matchup. And I got to call it colossal. And then the Giant. And Hollywood Hulk Hogan, the man that turned his back on a nation.
Ooh, what a move by Mysterio.
Yeah, Mysterio's got a bad knee, though, too. That right knee of his ain't doing too well.
He scissored Malenko and took him over. But as you said, look at Rey Mysterio Jr. He's hurt. His leg is hurt. Malenko taking advantage of the situation, tosses Mysterio back into the middle, and here comes Dean Malenko. He's going up. What a move by Rey Mysterio. He didn't ground him that time, Dusty, and here comes the Cruiserweight Champion of the World. He's trying to hook him up for what looks like it could be a superplex. Malenko with a jab, another jab to the midsection. And now launches Rey Mysterio Jr. right into the middle of the ring, and here comes the Iceman.
Got him pinned.
Over. Two. Kick out by Mysterio.
I thought he had him right there.
We have had so many near falls in this match already.
Inverted suplex, would that be what that's called?
That exactly is what it is. Put him nose first. You can see Rey Jr. grabbing for his nose. Again, going for what could be a power bomb. He did! Oh, man! Two, three, no,
oh,
two!
How did he get out of that? How did Jr. come out of that?
You talk about adrenaline, instinct. Rey Mysterio, what is he doing here? Block, right hand by Mysterio. He's going for the top rope. Catches him with a flying scissor. Hooks him up.
Boy, I tell you what a comeback win that would have been right there.
You are seeing one of the greatest matches, and I can only imagine what's going to happen tonight at Hog Wild. I mean, look at these two men right now. Cradled by Mysterio. And a two count. Oh, man.
So close yet so far away. Oh, man.
What a match by Rey Mysterio Jr. and Dean Malenko. Nice counter move by Mysterio. Look at this. Into a crucifix move.
He's got him.
He's got him. He got him.
Wow. What a victory.
Rey Mysterio Jr. What a win. Unbelievable.
What a big victory for Jr. right here. Oh, man. Wow. I'm sure Chris Benoit is watching from the wings as we get ready for Hog Wild.
All right, baby. Shecky, fire up the jet. We're heading for Sturgis, South Dakota. Hog Wild for the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. I'm Lee Marshall. Please call your cable operator right now. You get Hog Wild. We'll see you tonight on Saturday night.
There is no doubt about it, gentlemen. One of the most incredible turn of events. It happened on Hog Wild. Hulk Hogan attacks his close friend. That man, of course, the Booty Man, who he apparently suckered into coming in with an NWO t-shirt on, and then defaced
the WCW World Heavyweight Title.
You know, I wouldn't trust that situation, though. Remember when the Four Horsemen beat up the Booty Man?
Yes.
Hulk Hogan might have slapped his own friend around just to throw off suspicion, just to keep him from getting beat up again by the Dungeon of Doom or the Four Horsemen. Remember, don't trust anybody. The Booty Man was already a spy once for Hogan. Hogan could be setting up something. Don't trust anybody.
I'll tell you what, the way he got ragtag guys, New World Order, WCW, where the big boys played, still controversy. Hands haven't been dealt, Tony. I don't believe the whole hand has been dealt, really, by either organization. Eyes, of course, the best they are, WCW, where the big boys played. We're going to talk later on, Tony. I want to ask you a question right up front
okay.
About Nick Patrick, but right here, we see a man just coming off the Clash of Champions and a victory losing the ring as well to Eddie Guerrero.
How about it? Eddie Guerrero wins the Battle Bull ring. He has the ring in his possession, so Diamond Dallas now has to work on getting that Battle Bull ring back. In addition, Diamond Dallas has to be concerned now with not only Eddie Guerrero, but he also has to be concerned with Chavo Guerrero Jr. because he made a statement. He made his mark, so to speak, on the Guerrero family 2 nights ago.
The whole Guerrero family is up in arms over this thing with Dallas, and we are about the new world order.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, there's way too many Guerreros in the first place. Diamond Dallas Page has to be irate about the cheap victory Eddie Guerrero snatched over him. I think it was a fast count, more or less a fluke. I think Diamond Dallas will wind up back with the ring and take care of the Guerrero.
Chip Minton, the former bobsledder from the U.S. Olympic team, making his way through the WCW power plant, being very successful, and making one of his early matches here in WCW at WCW Pro.
Well, Chip Minton has a lot to learn. I'm still trying to figure out the correlation between bobsledding and professional wrestling. Chip Minton better stay at that power plant, or for him, it's going to be a long downhill ride.
Well, that was a civil twist of fate on the words right there, Tony. And one other thing is for certain, see how Dallas rebounds in this situation. After coming off the Clash of Champions, I might add, with Tony Schiavone.
Whoa!
With Silver Tongue. Let me tell you something. The Giant came back strong. I mean, real strong after the defeat, because nobody got chokeslammed like Chris Benoit.
Yes, fans, we're going to show you later on also some footage from the Clash of the Champions where Hulk Hogan retained the World Heavyweight Championship by the skin of his teeth. And if you didn't see it, fans, you're going to know what we're talking about, truly by the skin of his teeth. Here's the full-arm dragon twist. And over the top goes Chip Minton, the hair takedown. Diamond Dallas using every resource he can to get an advantage. And right between the shoulder blades, Diamond Dallas Page.
See, Chip Minton's going to have to get aggressive. He can't just sit there waiting for the bobsled to do all the work for him. This is wrestling, and you're going to have to go one-on-one. Diamond Dallas, not only is he a man on a mission now, he's a man on a mission that knows what he's doing.
Oh,
oh, you caught once.
Drop kick and a cover. We got a one count that time. Forearm shot, Chip Minton mounting a comeback here. Here's a reversal. DDP ducks his head. Chip Minton, great leg strength, but Diamond Dallas one step ahead.
Yeah, Dallas, tall guy, 6'5", hard to pull him down without momentum. Lift his arms up.
One count only that time. Chip Minton, great reversal. And the youngster.
Look at Diamond's wobbling. What's this kid waiting for? The sled? Get aggressive. Get him.
Well, that's just young inexperience.
That's
what's
right.
Going on there?
That's stupid.
Dallas Page possesses one of the great Indian holds in all of wrestling. We are talking about
Indian holds.
Indian. When you put somebody out, Indian. I'm not talking about Indian.
Okay.
Now, read my lip. And you've been on Nitro too long.
Oh, roll up one only. We have a tremendous Nitro card for this coming Monday that we'll be talking about during the course of this morning telecast. He took that move into a diamond cutter. That was awesome from DDP.
That's what I'm talking about.
Talking about rebounding after losing the Battle Bowl ring. One, two, three. Diamond Dallas is your winner over Chip Minton. A tremendous win for this guy.
There's a bobsled leaving in 5 minutes. Minton better be on it.
I like that, though. 5 minutes.
Five
minutes. Bobsled leaving in
you
five
like that?
Minutes.
Good. Why don't you hop on it with him?
What?
Diamond Dallas Page is your winner of the opening bout. Looking to rebound after the loss of the Clash. Here it is again.
Hard to do maneuver right here. Diamond Dallas waved his legs, blocked it in midair, reversed it upside down, and then put the lights out.
Still to come in this telecast on this Saturday morning, we have Jim Powers, Chris Benoit, and much more. Stay with us. W Pro, this is a very special morning for us. As a matter of fact, it is our last Saturday morning for WCW Pro, because beginning next weekend, there's going to be a change in the schedule for WCW Pro and WCW Main Event here on TBS. Here's how it works. Next Saturday morning at 9:05, WCW Main Event debuts. And then next Sunday night at 5:05 p.m. Eastern Time, WCW Pro comes your way. So there's a switch between the two programs. The Pro, Chris Cruz, hopefully he'll be back next week. We'll be on the nighttime with you guys. And Gene Okerlund, Bobby Heenan, in a pregame warm-up to the entire weekend with the Main Event starting next Saturday, every Saturday morning.
Well, it's about time they switched it. You know, I've been telling them to switch it for over a year now. It's been messing up my Saturday morning golf doing the Pro in the morning, so now I'm clear.
Yeah.
It's okay now.
You're clear.
He only has to work one day a week instead of two.
Yes.
That's a tough schedule.
Look out, Norman. Here I come.
It is Jim Powers and the Gambler in this one-on-one matchup here on WCW Pro Wrestling.
A couple of things to take a look at here, and my take on, Tony. I want to ask you the question, too, here. Since we have you here, Silver Tongue Tony Schiavone, I know Saturday night coming up later on, me and you talk about a lot of things on the mothership. But Nick Patrick, situation, he is in a corner, or is he really guilty in this situation with the New World Order? That's very important.
Well, I thought, and you go back to Hog Wild, when it appeared as if he hit the back of the knee of Lex Luger on purpose. Here's a roll-up by Jim Powers, and at a fast count. And then it looked like on Nitro this past Monday from Casper, Wyoming, that he grabbed the arm of Hall and pulled him out of the way during that impromptu tag team match. However, the statement he made this past Thursday after that outside interference in the triangle match makes me believe that Nick Patrick's on the up and up.
Well, he talked well. You know, he was Evelyn Rue reading school. You know what I mean? He talked soliloquy right down the line, got all his X's and O's and his verbs and adjectives going right. But I believe that he actually pulled. We're talking about number two. We're talking about the second thing that happened on the Nitro where he pulled Hall. Was it?
Yes.
Okay. That happened. Larry, what's your take on that thing?
Well, see, number one, I'm glad you're not a judge, because there's no evidence. There's no checks, that are canceled, signed, Hulk Hogan made out to Nick Patrick. I wouldn't jump to any conclusions. Referees are stuck in there. Little guys are scared for their own health and welfare with all these big guys. And I don't think Nick Patrick signed the tag. I wouldn't be surprised. I mean,
You don't
trust anybody.
Right. You don't trust anybody.
But don't jump to... That's what's letting the New World Order slip in here, is no one in WCW is standing behind anybody. They did it at the Clash, but can they maintain that attitude? If they don't, the New World Order will take over.
Fans, you can judge for yourself, because the replay of the Clash of the Champions is coming up this Thursday, the 22nd of August at 10:35 p.m. Eastern Time, right here on TBS. Fact of the matter is that Harlem Heat, they're still the World Tag Team Champions, but tonight on TBS, on Saturday night, a big return match, Harlem Heat and the Steiner Brothers for the World Tag Team title.
And I really look for a take on that situation there with the Steiner Brothers, really, Tony, as we go into the mothership tonight, and we're talking so much about the New World Order and everything, but right here in our own house, WCW, with the big boys play, World Tag Team title meaning so much. Steiner Brothers, I'm going to say tonight, really got a better than good shot at taking them titles from Harlem Heat.
Better than good? Is that like a 50-50?
Yeah. Sometimes you got a good shot of winning, you know what I mean? But this is like, I believe that tonight's going to be the night. I just believe that. They had a beat, Tony.
Yes,
they
did.
Before this guy right here, Nick Patrick, made the call, Larry. Made the call at the Clash of Champions.
Over the top goes Jim Powers, and a right-hand miss. And Powers rolls up the Gambler. One, two, no. Got a two count only.
Yeah, not enough weight over the shoulders. But look at Patrick's right there. He's right on it.
Doing a good job, yes. But I still agree with Dusty that it looked to me as if he pulled him out of the way intentionally in Casper, Wyoming, at Nitro. Speaking of Nitro, what a big main event we got coming up Monday night. Ric Flair and Arn Anderson against Sting and Lex Luger.
Wow.
Are you kidding me? And it seems that these four men have kind of been getting along, rising to the occasion as a unit against the NWO, but they will face each other as teams coming up this Monday.
Boy, I don't like to see that. I don't want to see that this Monday. That could start more dissension and give the New World Order more room to sneak in.
That's what
I don't
want.
Know about this.
All right, Jim Powers now sending the gambler to the corner here on the pro, a gut shot. Jim Powers, he is such a powerful man. And the fans love him, as you can hear.
He's a serious athlete. I mean, keeps himself in good shape, a lot of endurance. Should get a haircut. Too much hair makes a big handle to grab.
Power slam out of the left side. Raps, 1, 2, 3. Jim Whoa. Powers with the power slam gets the win on the pro.
That was a good move and a big win for Jim Powers. And we march on, Larry Legend. Silver Tongue Tony Schiavone talking about the New World Order. And boy, let me tell you something. I'm going to raise something else up to you about Hollywood Hulk Hogan when we come back in a minute.
All right, Larry, we're going to take one more look. The gambler arguing Nick Patrick, who holds firm with his decision that Jim Powers is your winner. Here it is again.
Well, Powers, he just put on the steam, kept going after the gambler, got aggressive. Right there is about 6 or 7 of them. One more for good measure. The gambler, he ran out of jokers, Tony. Couldn't play him, and Powers right there. Powers slammed the air right out of the gambler.
Still to come, Scott Norton, high voltage American male, Chris Benoit, and much more on the pro. Welcome back to WCW Pro. Time for some great tag team action and time for some young men who have made their way from obscurity through the WCW power plant and now making quite a name for themselves. Rage and chaos. Here comes high voltage here.
Hey, let me tell you something, guys. I'm going to ask this question one more time. Before we came back during the break, I saved it for this. Hulk Hogan, the New World Order. There's been 3 scenes.
Right.
There's been sightings of 4, 5, or 6. We don't know. Bottom line, they're going to have to start on each other sooner or later. Hulk Hogan, Kevin Nash, Paul, can Hogan beat either one of them guys? That's my question to you.
Well, I don't know the answer to that, but I know that they are some tremendous athletes.
Well, I haven't even thought about it. I'm still worried about the NWO beating our guys. I don't even think about them beating their own guys.
You're kidding. Hold on, guys.
What kind of question is that?
Wait a minute, you're kidding.
What's wrong, Drink?
Hey, I'm going to tell you what. I got a real scoop for you.
Okay, wait a minute.
Hey, I got to go. I'll be back here in a minute. No, I might not be. What? They're telling me. I like this. I got a scoop for you, and I'll bring it to you on Saturday night. I'm out of here.
Where you going?
Wait a minute. Dusty Rhodes is...
You can't leave now.
Dusty Rhodes getting up and leaving. He has been called back to the locker room area here on WCW Pro Wrestling. And apparently tonight on WCW Saturday Night, we'll have a big scoop for us. So, Larry, I guess it's you and
me. He ran out for a big scoop?
Yes.
Yeah, he's talking about an ice cream cone.
No, he's not. He's talking about some information, and I'm sure it has to do with the outsiders, with Hall, with Nash, with the possible fourth man, who is he, or the fifth man.
Maybe that's what it is. Maybe Dusty got a scoop on the fourth guy.
Maybe so. Fans, we'll find out. Here we want to tell you, though, that Dusty will join us tonight for WCW Saturday Night, 1 hour, 6:05 Eastern Time.
Is Dusty out of the hallway?
He is back in the locker room area right now, I understand.
He can't hear this now.
I'm not sure. I don't know.
Because he shouldn't be eating any more ice cream cones.
Would you stop? There's no more Dusty Rhodes here on Saturday morning, but here...
Hip, hip!
Here we are, Larry. And, you know, tonight on Saturday night, some tremendous... action, some great tag team action. 1 hour, Dusty will join us at that time. And we want to remind you that WCW Monday Nitro will be coming your way this coming Monday, 8:00 Eastern Time. Larry, you and I will be there for hour number one. We have some great action. VK Wall Street and Hacksaw Jim Duggan, a return match from the Clash of the Champions. What a match that was. Coming up at Nitro. No doubt about it, as you know, as everyone else knows, the only place to be for Monday Night Pro Wrestling action is TNT.
Monday Night Sports is TNT, that's it. But I don't like the main event that's coming up on Nitro. I really don't want to see the Horsemen in there against Lex and Sting. This isn't the time for any more animosities to build. This is the time for World Championship Wrestling to stick together, or the new world order is going to take over. No one trusts anybody, and that's a bad sign. They even think the referees are on the take.
Well, that remains to be seen. A back elbow from Scotty Riggs and a forearm shot to Rage, sending the youngster back to the corner. Into the other side he goes, and here's Scotty Riggs up on the corner. Being down and sending the man out all the way to the other side of the ring. WCW Pro Wrestling here on TBS. Coming up in just a few moments, we will take you back to the Clash of the Champions and show you Hulk Hogan and Ric Flair. You'll see and hear the comments. Yes, Hogan was seconds away, we believe, and even think that he didn't give up. However, thanks to Hall and Nash, he retains the World Tag Team title. A cover by Mark Bagwell, got a one count.
Well, a title retained without honor is not something to brag about.
Well, I would agree with that. A title even received without honor, something not to brag about. And for you fans who saw Hog Wild, you know how Hulk Hogan last Saturday won the World Tag Team Championship. We're going to show you his first title defense as it happened this past Thursday. And certainly he is not a man of honor anymore in his career. He has crossed that bridge. The river is up. It's high. The bridge is washed out. Buddy, there's no going back.
Oh, but Bagwell better get back. High Bold is doing a nice attempt here of trying to maintain some ring positioning and control. But Bagwell slipped under his legs.
Bagwell ducked that time. That time, a thundering shoulder block from Mark Bagwell.
Right smack in the face. You can see the head snap back. Bagwell drags him over, makes the tag. So far, so good for the American males.
Scotty Riggs and the double team from the American males. Very important match for Riggs and Bagwell. A win here against this up-and-coming tag team who's really turned a lot of heads, made such an impression from promoters around the world. High Voltage and Riggs and Bagwell get a win here, and they're on their way back. And for High Voltage, a win here, and they are solidly a top contender to the world. Oh, to the world tag team title. If Chaos can find his teeth.
Yeah, his head snapped back. That means Rick's caught him right underneath the chin, right in the lower teeth, snapped it back. But again, he had him in the corner. He should have reached out and tagged Bagwell. He pushed him all the way back. See, that backfired on him.
He ducks to Scotty Riggs. Scotty Riggs is up in the air, and Chaos takes advantage of that and sends him crashing to the top rope.
Yeah, right across the throat. Riggs, he had it made. All he had to do was drag him over and tag Bagwell, but they forget the golden rule. More tags, the merrier. Look at this, is the positioning in the tag team that Chaos and Rage want to do.
To the gut. Rage maybe wasting a little time right there, but Rage picks up Scotty Riggs. Look at this suplex. Holds him up high and drops him down, and that was textbook suplex, Larry.
Yeah, let the blood rush down to the head when you feel the man sucking that oxygen. Drop him down. That expands all the pressure on the intestines. That's what causes the pain. That's why they say get the wind knocked out of you.
Yeah.
Because that's when it hurts, when you got the wind in you.
Oh, thank you, Dr. Zabisco. Very good.
Well, you got to know how to hurt people to the utmost.
Yes, you do. And fans throughout the years know that you know how to. There's a power slam. Here's a cover, and that was kind of a nonchalant cover that time. And what we're seeing here is a little bit of inexperience from High Voltage. Certainly long on talent, short on experience, though, and it won't be long before they're in the winner's circle, maybe here in this match.
Well, they got the fundamentals down, keeping control of the corner, making a lot of tag, but they're having problems finishing off the man.
That was a big roundhouse clothesline, but Scott Riggs did not miss. Here comes Chaos, and Riggs goes down hard. Oh, my.
Bam! What a clothesline!
How about that one? And the fans explode as both members of High Voltage find themselves back on the mat.
Yeah, but Riggs is on the mat, too. He's got to find Bagwell. Bagwell's got his arm out. But can Riggs make it over in time? That's the big question.
Riggs reaching out to his partner. Bagwell, you see Bagwell say, come on. Come on, yeah. The tag's made.
Oh.
On the other side, too. Foot in the face of Chaos. Mark Bagwell. Fans are standing here. Marcus Bagwell, member of the American Males, controlling the action in the ring, taking both men down. Oh, they love it here on the Pro.
Yeah, well, you better stay on him.
Here's the whip in. Pick up, back body drop. Almost right into your living room with that one, fans. Mark Bagwell on the attack once again. Maybe the bridge suplex. That is the bridge suplex. One, two, a save. Riggs cut him off, and Riggs cuts him off.
He had his hands locked. Riggs obviously frustrated. Bagwell thrown out to the floor, but Riggs isn't a legal man there now.
Here's the double team. Rage gets a rake to the eyes. He's on the outside.
Yeah, but he's not legal. Bagwell's the legal man.
And Bagwell's up on top. He's trying to pick him up for a pile driver. Bagwell! One, two, three. Well, they earned that one. And they defeated a fine young tag team in high voltage in a very, very big win for the American Males this Saturday morning on the Pro.
Well, I think high voltage got a little caught up in the confusion. They had the emotions running high, gave it their best shot. Just got a little confused at the end there. Riggs came in out of frustration. High voltage wound up grabbing him. Kind of took for granted that Bagwell was out of the picture, but he was not out of the picture, and he was the legal man.
All right, fans, it was a great win, and here it is again, Larry.
Well, here it is again. See, right there, right in the mouth. Bagwell caught him. Bagwell being the legal man. Chaos didn't see him coming, Tony, until it was too late, and it was 1-2-3.
Fans, when we come back on the Pro, we'll take you to the Clash of the Champions. Should Hogan still be the world champ? Well, he is, and you'll find out how after this.
Good morning again, Hotline fans here on the Pro. What an interesting 7 days. Some say it was horrendous. First Sturgis, South Dakota, then out of Casper, Wyoming, then to Colorado Springs in Denver, in the Rocky Mountains in the great state of Colorado. A couple of newcomers will be arriving very shortly at World Championship Wrestling. Contractually, they may not be on paper yet, so I can't talk about it on the air. I will talk about it today during my exclusive hotline report. And what about new champions here in World Championship Wrestling? And the inside scoop on the fourth man of the New World Order. I'll have all that and more all day long today on the WCW Hotline at 1-900-909-9900. Call the hotline right now.
All right, fans, welcome back to the Pro. We take you back to this past Thursday, live in Denver. Hulk Hogan, Ric Flair. Take a look at how this one ended on the Clash. All right, fans, we are back, and we have just seen the footage of Ric Flair and Hulk Hogan. Hulk Hogan, I think, even heard Bobby the Brain Heenan say he gave up. But here comes the New World Order. Here comes Hall and Nash, the Outsiders. Hulk Hogan retains the title. If this is any indication of what's going to happen, Hogan is using every stop measure he can, and he'll hold on to that title for a long time.
Yeah, well, at least the Horsemen came out, Luger and Sting came out, at least World Championship Wrestling. The athletes are realizing they better stick together to whatever degree they can possibly manage. Otherwise, the door is going to be wide open for the New World Order to come in.
Scott Flash Norton to go up against Mark Starr in this match here on WCW Pro. Also, as you know, the Macho Man Randy Savage, who was brutally injured by Hulk Hogan this past Monday, live in Casper, Wyoming, with the chair, unable to compete in the Clash of the Champions this past Thursday. But we do understand the Macho Man Randy Savage will face the Giant, scheduled this Monday, live on Nitro. If that is the case, you can better believe the Giant's going to try to choke slam and maybe open that injury in the back of the Macho Man's head.
Well, no doubt in my mind, if the Giant gets his hands around the throat of Savage, he's going up. And you know what Sir Isaac Newton said? Once you go up,
you got to come down.
Especially on choke slam.
Yes, just ask Chris Benoit what happened. And we'll see Benoit a little bit later in this telecast. Scott Flash Norton, a backhanded chop. It's really hard to be able to gear yourself to go up against a man the size and the demeanor of Scott Flash Norton, one of the biggest, strongest, and meanest in World Championship Wrestling here.
Yeah, he's an explosive guy. He can move that weight. And when you can move that weight, you can just fly around, cream somebody. He just caught Mark Starr in the corner. This guy's got no wind left in him, and Norton knows that he can feel it already.
Here's a knee left. Scott Norton Flash, as they call him, is certainly one of the most powerful men. Fans, do not forget to join us for WCW Monday Nitro. It is going to be absolutely exciting this coming Monday as we said, and you talked about, Larry, as we saw Sting and Lex helping out the Horsemen and Ric Flair in the efforts against the New World Order. That notwithstanding, also, we're going to see Sting and Lex against the team of Ric Flair and Arn Anderson as a tag team main event at Nitro this Monday. And that should be interesting, to say the least.
It'll be a great match, but again, I don't think it's the right time for that. It's going to cause dissension, no matter what happens, no matter who wins.
Well, it's going to be exciting. As a matter of fact, this just kicks off the entire weekend. WCW's main event on Sunday, and then tonight, 1 hour of Saturday night, the Giant in action. World Tag Team title will be on the line. The Steiners and Harlem Heat in a return match, and much more as you take another look at this great crowd on hand here at the Disney MGM Studios.
Boy, Mark Starr, he's barely getting up. I think Norton's just playing with this guy now. Oh, he missed something there. A dropkick in midair, but didn't do much to Norton.
Look, he's going for the knees. He's going for the leg and still cannot get the big guy off his feet. Mark Starr shoots him to the far side. Dropkick. Norton just shrugged that one off.
Bounced off that guy.
Incredible, the power of Scott Flash Norton. Norton now picks. This could be a shoulder breaker coming here. He's got him over his own shoulder. This is it. It's the big shoulder breaker. From Scott Norton, that's all, Larry.
Mark Starr did not bring his kryptonite, Tony, and it's over.
Scott Norton, decisive win, still feeling the effects of the breakup of his team and still looking for his former partner, the Ice Train. Back with our main event on the Pro after this timeout. Welcome back. It's main event time here on WCW Pro Wrestling, and we've had a tremendous hour. Any sign of Dusty Rhodes making his way back here?
Well, he had this big scoop. I think Dusty's got a line on the fourth man in the New World Order, but I don't see him coming back here yet.
Well, I think if you'll recall, Dusty said he will have an information for us tonight on WCW Saturday night.
Maybe they got Dusty.
You mean either they jumped him or they got him on their side? What are you saying?
I mean, maybe they jumped him.
Well, they could have. We will check back here and find out. Hopefully, we need more than three guys to jump him, I can tell you that.
You need a herd.
There you see some fans as they await this match and await WCW Monday Nitro. Live, 2 full hours coming up this coming Monday. We look forward to having you with us. It has set the standard for professional wrestling. It is the most watched weekly television program on cable TV. It is WCW Monday Nitro. It is live each and every Monday. And here's the desperado, the youngster Joe Gomez.
Desperate for a victory, Joe Gomez here wants to make a big name for himself. He's got the golden opportunity against Chris Benoit if he can beat him. And boy, that's something that's easily said, very hard to do.
And you'll notice also that when Chris Benoit walked out, he came out to the ring by himself. No Miss Elizabeth, no woman, no Deborah McMichael. What is the reason behind that? If you saw the Clash of the Champions, you may know a little bit about it. If not, we will be talking about what happened to Chris Benoit and how it pertains to the ladies at ringside, especially women. And we'll have our main event match and more on the Pro after this timeout. Stay with us. Main event time here on the Pro. Before the match gets underway, we want to wish a very speedy recovery to the host of WCW Pro, Chris Cruz. We understand Chris had appendicitis this week and was hospitalized. We are understanding that he's doing okay. Chris, hurry up and get well. Get back here on the Pro. As a matter of fact, Chris will join you with the Pro next Sunday night at 5:05 Eastern Time as the Pro moves to Sunday night. The main event moves to Saturday morning starting next weekend on TBS.
If he feels better.
He feels better.
He's in the hospital.
Yes, he is.
Well, better him than me.
Well, I tell you, Chris, a great announcer and a great guy. We hope to get him back here very, very soon. All right, Joe Gomez.
Doesn't have to be like next week, though, does it?
Yeah, as soon as he can get back, yes.
I think for Dusty to get back here with this rumor, you know, it's in my mind now. I'm dying to know. I hope he's not at the concession stand.
In the little mind games that goes on between you and Dusty, Dusty wins again, doesn't he? He's got you all flustered.
Well, I think it's an excuse he ran to the hot dog stand is
no,
what he did.
No, he did not. No, he did not.
Going to be a scoop in this.
Okay, Chris Benoit getting the advantage of Joe Gomez. No doubt about it, Benoit intimidating. A man who knows what he's doing in the ring.
Well, look how he's got those knuckles turned in. Benoit, he's got the good gripper. He knows how to hurt you. And he's got Gomez in trouble. Even when Gomez stands up, look at how Benoit moves. Always crisp, always a snap to his movement. Benoit is always in balance.
Fans, Thursday night, Chris Benoit to face the Giant. The match didn't take long. The Giant got the choke slam, picked Benoit up high, way high, slammed him down and won the match. But right before that happened, Benoit was tied up, literally, trying to get his leather vest off. Woman trying to pull it off and really got him all tangled up to where he was defenseless against the Giant. The question is, did Woman do that intentionally or not? What happened? And as a result, there is more friction, and Benoit came out here by himself.
Well, I think it's just maybe a little bit of friction in there. A nice move by Gomez right there, but I think it was just an accident. Woman, you know how women are emotionally unstable, was trying to get the thing off. His arm got caught in the rope in the vest. He couldn't move it. The Giant came right over, and, you know, without speed, you know, Benoit was easy prey for the Giant.
Yes.
But again, I think it's smart. Leave the women where they belong. Let them fold some clothes. Do a dish.
Wow.
Keep away from the ring.
Wow, I get a heat just sitting next to you on that line. My goodness. Nevertheless,
at least Benoit wised up the hard way.
You know, and I'm not so sure. Maybe you're thinking, Larry, that she just messed up and she shouldn't be there. I'm thinking it was premeditated.
You think Woman's with the New World Order?
I don't know. I mean, you can't trust anyone. Well, Something is going on here.
I know you can't trust anybody, but
it all starts,
what's Woman going to do?
It all starts back when Benoit had his feud going with Kevin Sullivan, and he tried to hurt the neck, and did hurt the neck of Sullivan. Wouldn't stop. A woman came out during the pay-per-view, tried to get him to stop. Something's going on there. Hopefully, over the next couple of weeks, we will find out. But meanwhile, we're taking a look at Chris Benoit, who absorbed that onslaught that time.
Yeah, see, Joe Gomez, he's wrestling his heart out, but he's doing it like an inexperienced guy. And he got caught.
One, two, almost got a win, did Gomez.
Yes, he got a move in there, but didn't follow it up. Benoit's back to his feet, back to his balance. I wish Dusty gets back. Maybe he knows the scoop on Woman, too.
Fans, Dusty will be back, I understand, tonight. 6:05 Eastern time for 1 hour of WCW Saturday night. Should be a tremendous telecast. The Giant in action, the Steiners, Harlem Heat, much more at 6:05 Eastern time tonight on TBS. And next Saturday at this time, Gene Okerlund, Bobby Heenan with the main event. The pregame show, the kickoff to a big weekend. Of course, it starts with the Pro, goes on to Saturday night, Sunday night, and then Nitro live every Monday. Joe Gomez, a lot of determination in that young man right there. Well, he knows what he's got ahead of him here.
Well, he moved the knee up to the head, but see, he didn't straighten out his body, which means he didn't have pressure on the arm and the elbow, and that let Benoit slip back up to his feet, and that led Gomez into getting dinked again.
A headbutt that time by Chris Benoit. Benoit on the attack and a backhand chop. Chris Benoit again. Benoit will send Gomez in. He ducks.
No,
buddy, home. Gomez stumbled that time, hit the apron. Oh, and Gomez goes to the floor.
And he hit the floor, too. Benoit right out after him. I think Gomez took his best shot and missed. If Benoit just keeps his cool here, this kid should be easy pickings now.
No question about that. Chris Benoit on the attack again to Joe Gomez. Joe Gomez shot to the near side rope. Oh, my goodness. A big clothesline. Benoit, member of the Horsemen. Some people feel maybe pound for pound the best in WCW. That's debatable, but he is certainly one of the best. And he has become a very solid member of this Horsemen team.
Gomez better get his hair cut. There's too much hair there. See how the guys grab it? Makes a good handle, grab the hair, control the whole body.
No question, it is a deterrent for Joe Gomez, but he is still learning his craft, and there's no question that in the years to come, not too far in the future, Joe Gomez is going to be a big factor in singles competition.
If he survives.
If he survives, and that's a great point. Here's a slam, a scoop slam. Survival is of utmost importance in this sport, even more so now than ever, because your enemies are hitting you with NWCW, and from the outside, literally, with the outsiders in the NWO. No one in WCW has been safe. And what's going on with the referee?
Boy, it's got to be tough even for these newcomers like Gomez to come in, because immediately a lot of guys aren't going to trust you right off the bat. They're going to think you would Hogan in the New World Order.
Right. Absolutely. That's a good point. And so the New World Order has done what it wanted to do, create chaos and mayhem in WCW while destroying from the back end. And
well, years ago, there was a guy from Russia named Khrushchev that said, "We will destroy you from within." He used to take his shoe off and pound the table.
Yes.
Reminds me of Hulk Hogan, but they're doing the same thing mentally. They're infiltrating from within. WCW better come to grips and stick by each other, or that New World Order will sneak in.
Joe Gomez attempting to backslide. He's got the leverage down on the knees. One. Benoit got out in only a one count that time. And immediately Benoit, Mr. Offense, kicks Joe Gomez in the sternum, coming out of the backslide.
And that's the secret. Gomez hits a move, but he stops. Benoit gets caught in a move, but he doesn't stop. He explodes, gets his balance, and retaliates. That's the kind of offense Gomez and the younger neophytes are going to have to learn to master. One move is never enough. Combination wrestling is the secret. And this could be the end of Gomez right here.
Chris Benoit taking flight here, the member of the Horseman.
Oh!
Missed everything that time. Gomez, a defensive move, rolling to his right, out of the way. And now, an onslaught. Onslaught of his own, right to the top of the head.
Got Benoit wobbly. That's something you don't see too often. Can Gomez follow up? He does with the backdrop.
Gomez with a lot of fire and vigor now. Here's a scoop and slam. Joe Gomez may be a few seconds away. Well, he's wasting a lot of time going here, guys.
You got to watch your opponent, Benoit. He's not moving much, but Gomez is taking too much time.
And everybody ran out of the way of that one, referee included. Nobody at home on that one. Chris Benoit seizing the opportunity, almost like a half camel clutch here, yeah. Pulling up on the head, and that is it.
Yeah, he seized that arm, hooked it back. Look where the pressure is. It's not below the chin, it's above it, above the eyes. That's where you can get the leverage and crank that neck back. And young Joe Gomez, we can nickname him Flying Dummy, completely missed Benoit, but Benoit didn't miss his opportunity.
All right, as we take a look once again, our thanks to Larry Zbysko and Dusty Rhodes.
No, wait, where is Dusty Rhodes?
I will find him tonight at 6:05 Eastern Time. The Pro moves to Sunday nights. Next Sunday, main event here next Saturday morning. For Dusty, for Larry, I'm Tony Schiavone. See you tonight, 6:05 on Saturday night.
Sunday debut of WCW Pro here on TBS Destination Sunday. Hi, everyone. I'm Cruz, along with the living legend Larry Zbysko and the American Dream Dusty Rhodes. And gentlemen, we are still rocking and reeling from the new alliance of Lex Luger and Sting, along, Dusty, with Arn Anderson and the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
On behalf of the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, legend, Larry Zbysko, Christopher Cruz, welcome from me to Sunday evening. We're talking new time slots for the Pro. Deal with the devil. Simple. Deal with the devil. Sting and Luger made a deal with the devil with Arn Anderson, Nature Boy Ric Flair, this past Nitro. Talked about it all weekend, guys. Legend. I know for a fact there's going to be trouble brewing in fall brawl because these four guys cannot coexist in the wall game.
Larry, you were there live at Nitro. It was a real shocker.
Well, let me disagree with the American Dream. Deal with the devil, maybe, but a must. Something WCW athletes have to do, and that is stick together. If you guys stick together, then we turn Hulk Hogan into the Pied Piper of Hamlin. We shove a piccolo in his yap, and he's followed into the river by a horde of rats, the New World Order.
All right, and also Rey Mysterio Jr. in a cruiserweight title defense right here as we said the debut of WCW Pro on Sundays on TBS. Now let's go to the ring.
Hello, baby. This is the Big Papa, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, right here. Sunday afternoon, TBS on 5 WCW with the Big Boy Play. Legendary Larry Zbysko, Christopher Cruz.
lot to talk about this weekend. All we talked about was New World Order, and did Steve make a mistake or not when he accepted Flair and Ines, their partners, won in the wall game. Larry Legends, the Bisco, it's good to see you on a Sunday afternoon. Get you away from that golf game.
Well, I got the golf game in early, but let's talk about the paranoia that's coming to WCW.
Paranoia.
Talk about making deals with the devil, the predicament you think Lex and Stinger in. They had to do what they did, but again, even paranoid against the officials here, pointing their fingers at Nick Patrick, trying to pass the proverbial buck.
Stop it.
A man who just recently purchased a huge home well beyond his salary range and is reported to have all kinds of new Armani suits. What's the deal there, Chad Brock?
The deal is, on Nick Patrick, he sold out to the New World Order.
That is the deal.
That ain't no paranoia to it. The bottom line, I ain't paranoid. WCW said on this past Nitro, you were there, Larry, said, come on. Eric Bischoff and all of us say, come on and get this thing. I think the shock is over with the New World Order. I think Fall Brawl will tell the story of what's going to go on here at WCW with the big boys playing.
Well, we're going to find out. Another shocker coming up at Fall Brawl. Who is the fourth man? We presume there's a fourth man. There are four individuals from World Championship Wrestling. Sting, Lex Luger, Arn Anderson, and the Nature Boy Ric Flair against Hollywood Hulk Hogan, Nash.
Oh, he tried to cross the line, but Mean Mike hit him up at the pass.
Indeed, Mean Mike did just do that. My thanks, by the way, last week to Tony Schiavone for covering while I was getting my appendix taken out. Kind of an unscheduled visit to the hospital.
You know, you still don't look good.
I never did, really, did I?
No.
Well, we're glad to have you back and kick this thing off right here on the Pro. As I said, right here, Sunday afternoon. What better place to be than PBS?
Thanks as well.
Chad Brock. He's trying to mount some offense, right?
He sure is.
But I'm going to tell you what,
well,
he cannot make stupid mistakes like he's done.
Oh!
And expect to win, because that happens to you right there.
Yeah, Enos caught him right underneath the chin, snapped his head back, but don't waste time here. Get on him.
Thanks for the cards, letters, phone calls, and especially the support of friends and family, people like Elisa and Stephanie Barber in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, the site of Fall Brawl.
He nailed him against the rope.
You got two cards.
September the 15th.
You had two people write you about the illness.
No, I had many people write and call and all those things and telegram, but two people in particular were very supportive during that difficult time that I had, and it's good to be back here on the Pro in this, the debut program on Sunday, Discovery Sunday on TBS, and Mean Mike Enos with a belly-to-belly suplex over the top of the head.
Yeah, but he's talking to Nick Patrick,
which we all know is an exercise in futility. Nick Patrick has got his own sense of where he wants to go with his career and who he wants to be with, and that's the New World Order.
Don't be paranoid!
Power slam.
He got him up for a cover right here. I believe this off of Chad Brock.
And
at least he had to try. Chad Brock went in, drew the assignment, drew the bull, said, turn him out. I'll try to ride him right here on the Pro. The Pro team is hot this Sunday afternoon.
Chad Brock, the singing cowboy. He's a big fan of country western music, but he's singing the blues now after his defeat at the hands of Mean Mike Enos. A whole lot more to come here on the Pro, here on TBS on Sunday in a moment. Thanks, Mean Gene. Indeed, we are going to be part of Fall Brawl live. It is Sunday, September 15th, just a few Sundays away, in fact. Only on pay-per-view. You must make that all-important phone call to your cable company. Gentlemen, we're back with action here now. The Faces of Fear from the Dungeon of Doom. And the Dungeon of Doom to be represented, of course, at Fall Brawl by the Giant as he faces the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Well, I think Macho Man bit off more than he could chew this time. And, of course, all the rumors flying around the world about who's the fourth man in the New World Order. I don't think it matters. Once they get inside that cage, once they get inside War Games, nobody can leave. There is no escape, and nobody can infiltrate from the outside.
That's right, indeed. Two rings, all within one cage and a roof. Just there are doors on each side, and as you said, Larry, no one can get in, no one can get out once War Games has begun.
I tell you what, when you talk about Dungeon of Doom and the Horsemen and everything going on within WCW and the battles that have to be fought within the greatest organization in the world, WCW, where the big boys play, and then you throw the New World Order in. You know, I had got such a hot tip last weekend. Y'all saw how excited I was when I leaped
leaped out of there.
You predicted that on last Monday's Nitro, the New World Order would appear.
Well, I really predicted there would be big news.
Right.
Well, the big news hit, brother.
Absolutely.
And we're going to see what transpired with Sting and Luger and the Horsemen, actually, that happened in the ring from this past Monday Nitro. Now, you look for the 2 hours, the hottest program on television tomorrow, TNT Monday Nitro, coming live tomorrow, TNT. And I'm telling you, you keep your eyes wide open, because not only Nick Patrick has infiltrated the New World Order, you know what I mean? He's there, one of them. Believe me, he is. We'd love to find out more tomorrow night on Monday night.
Paranoia. Live. Paranoia.
I ain't paranoia.
Well, here's maybe another instance of paranoia. What if the fourth member of the New World Order is either somebody here already in World Championship Wrestling, or is one of the four participants on the other side of the New World Order at Fall Brawl? What if it's Sting or Lex Luger or Ric Flair or Arn Anderson? And that's Braun the Leprechaun.
Yeah, and he is quick as the cat. Braun the Leprechaun, he is a secret weapon of the Dungeon of Doom, and he is a vicious, vicious leprechaun. Braun the Leprechaun.
Well, he just ran through there. Must be searching for the pot of gold.
Well, these guys are awesome. I'm talking face to fear. You were right when you were talking about, you know, the situation there coming into Fall Brawl. What's going on? Man, I guarantee you one thing. The New World Order, now then, they know we're here and we ain't going nowhere. So let's get it on.
A vicious slam, and that should do it. The Barbarian. Man, what a great team. The Barbarian and Mang Meg, so appropriately named, the Faces of Fear. And Dusty, you are right. There is so much to be concerned about here in World Championship Wrestling. Who do you trust? Basically, nobody. You can't trust anyone. Barbarian with Billy Payne. This is going to be painful up on the third row.
Oh, he snap him out there, Payne. This guy is flat, and of course the bad news now is he tagged in Ming.
Both these guys are deadly. I'm talking about Ming and the Barbarian. Here we are in the afternoon on Sunday.
The Golden
Getting
Spike.
Right. The what?
The Spike.
The Golden Spike.
The Asiatic Golden Spike, and that's going to do it. Ming victorious, along with the Barbarian, the Faces of Fear, here this afternoon on TBS on Destination Sunday. I'm WCW Pro. Still to come, we'll hear from Mean Gene Okerlund news about the hotline. Also, more from Nitro, exclusive footage from Nitro, and Rey Mysterio Jr. defends the Cruiserweight title in a moment on TBS.
Well, Brain, yesterday during my hotline report, I drew some comparisons between the NWO and World Championship Wrestling. I understand that you have access to some more information that you'd like to share with us.
Well, with my great ability as a broadcast journalist, I can get places, I can get in and out of places that other people could never get into. I make Geraldo Rivera look like he's doing a farm weather report in Omaha, Nebraska. What I have now is news on the NWO. I know inside stuff nobody else knows.
Well, tell us.
On the hotline.
On the hotline?
On the hotline.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, on the hotline tonight, running up until midnight, call Bobby the Brain Heenan, 1-900-909-9900. Call right now.
What?
Welcome back to WCW Pro here on TBS Destination Sunday. Cruz, the Dream, the Legend, and thank you, Mean Gene. Of course, we'll call the hotline, get all the scoops from the man who knows it all, Mean Gene Okerlund. Now, the WCW Cruiserweight title on the line. There he is, Chavo Guerrero Jr., 25 years old, 2 years a pro, facing off against the superb, the great Rey Mysterio Jr.
It'll be a good matchup. We also got a good main event coming up, Sergeant Pippen against Diamond Dallas Page. And you know how the Guerreros feel about Diamond Dallas.
Hey, Diamond Dallas Page defeated by Eddie Guerrero recently here on World Championship Wrestling. Luke or no, he defeated him. He pinned him 1-2-3. He won the Battle Bowl ring. He became the Lord of the Ring. And what happened? DDP, in a fit of rage, he executed that diamond cutter three separate times on Eddie Guerrero. Guerrero was lifeless, limp. In comes Chavo Guerrero to the rescue, the nephew of Eddie Guerrero. And as a result, as we see Rey Mysterio Jr., we're going to see at Fall Brawl, Winston-Salem, North Carolina, it's Chavo Guerrero Jr. in a grudge match against Diamond Dallas Page and Dusty. I hope DDP gets what's coming to him.
Well, let me tell you what, DDP, legendary as Larry is, Eddie Guerrero, I'm talking about my Texican friend, really put it down and got that fall on Diamond Dallas Page. Now, that thing has erupted. Everything at WCW has erupted. We talked so much about Fall Brawl coming up on pay-per-view. Talked about TNT Monday Night Raw coming up live, the hottest show on television. coming up tomorrow live every Monday night. Bottom line in this situation right here, you guys are in for a real great matchup right here. Junior versus Junior. Guerrero Jr., Mysterio Jr., Cruiserweight title, quick, fast, high-risk maneuvers. It's going to be something right here. Right here this afternoon. Sunday afternoon. Ain't no walk in the park.
Nope, and I'm betting a wad on Junior.
Good choice. A sit-out attempt there by Chavo Guerrero Jr., as we said, the nephew of Eddie Guerrero. But because they were so close in age, raised essentially as brothers, they think of themselves almost as contemporaries, and certainly Chavo Guerrero trying to make a name for himself in wrestling, much as Eddie Guerrero has so quickly here in World Championship Wrestling. At 21 years old, Rey Mysterio Jr. is already a seven-year veteran.
Phenomena. He's a phenomenon.
They don't have schools in Mexico.
Yeah, they do have schools in Mexico. I'm not saying full-time. I'm saying a seven-year veteran. Now Rey Mysterio Jr. has come to World Championship Wrestling, and 2 months ago, on Monday Nitro, the hottest wrestling show on television, he defeated Dean Malenko for the Cruiserweight
title. Larry, let me ask you a question here. What does Chavo Guerrero Jr. got to do to beat Rey Mysterio Jr. right here? What does he have to do?
He's going to have to slow him down. Rey Mysterio Jr., very quick. This guy defies gravity, gives up weight, but no one's been beating him in the speed department. And I remember Chavo Guerrero's father. I used to beat him up here and there around Los Angeles. We'll see if the Junior has got a chip off the old block.
This is the first ever matchup between these two. So much history with Rey Mysterio Jr. and Eddie Guerrero. They have teamed up. They have also opposed one another. And look at that. Mysterio almost went out of the ring. I don't think Guerrero intended for Mysterio to be injured, however. Just wants to beat him clean. And look out, Mysterio. He will land on his feet in a beautiful dropkick.
Yeah, landed clean. Caught Chavo Jr. off guard. And
a full body fake. Up and over. Slingshot. And he lands right on Chavo Guerrero.
He planted him too right there. Anytime you do high risk maneuvers at that right there, I believe both men sometime become injured. I think in a cruiserweight division, the man that makes a really high risk, big bad mistake comes out on the losing end. And that was a hard blow taken right there by Chavo Guerrero. And Larry, let me make an exception to one thing you said earlier as I was listening to you. Bottom line, you are the legend. I have seen you in the greatest matches. You've held world titles. You were a world champion, but I know Chavo Guerrero, great athlete that it was, and I know that he took you to the post a couple of times now. They wasn't all victories, was they?
Yeah, they were.
By Chavo, that's what I thought.
No, come on.
Attempted a pin. He's got to get, no, he's not going to get him. He's just got a one and a half count there.
One thing the Guerreros do know that I have had experience with, these guys will fight to the end. They will not concede in there. Of course, we've seen big attacks on Rey Mysterio Jr. For a small guy, he can take a beating and keep on coming back at you.
Indeed, Rey Mysterio Jr. at Fall Brawl War Games. He is going to face Super Kalo. He has already faced off against Dean Malenko, Psychosis, Ultimo Dragon, and Rey Mysterio Jr. has truly captured the imagination, the hearts of so many of our young fans, Dusty.
You know what, guys? Each and every Sunday afternoon right here on TBS, I will guarantee as we follow the mothership, as we get ready to go into TNT Monday Nitro Live, and we come off Saturday night's mothership and that big opening of everything that's happening on the weekends on Saturday morning here on TBS. Take a look and listen to all the great athletes that will pass this way. Remember this, WCW where the big boys play. We ain't going nowhere. New World Order, if you will. Hollywood Hulk Hogan, Hall and Nash. Who are the other people? Fall Brawl. We talking cage with a roof, two rings. Brutal battle. Sting stepped out and has made, I believe, maybe a mistake by asking Flair and I to come his way, Larry.
I don't think he had a choice. You know, sometimes when you play that human game of chess, you look at the board and you've only got one move, only one possibility, one chance you have to take or concede your king. And I think they did what they had to do. A question still remains. Who is the fourth man? Who can be trusted? Do not let the paranoia spread.
You're using that a lot, paranoia.
Larry, I see it happening, and I don't like it.
Larry, you are so right that indeed Sting certainly didn't want to team up with Arn Anderson and Ric Flair. Certainly Lex Luger didn't, but they realized it was their only hope against the outsiders, of whom we know only three And the question is one of the four outsiders, will the fourth outsider eventually turn out to be an insider here in World Championship Wrestling? Could it
See?
Be Ric Flair,
paranoid.
Arn Anderson, Lex Luger, or Sting? I don't think it's paranoia. I think it's just being very concerned. Whoever thought Hulk Hogan would turn the fans the way he has?
Good point.
From the Cohen Nobo tie-up to the standing side headlock, Chavo Guerrero now taking it to the Cruiserweight Champion. Of course, Rey Mysterio Jr. very closely aligned with Conan, the Mexican Heavyweight Champion, who defends that Mexican Heavyweight Championship against Psychosis at Fall Brawl. Chavo Guerrero, no.
Yeah, he caught him right in the leg. And what's with all these Mexicans? Is this like a NAFTA deal? Are American wrestlers out of work?
I'm not qualified to discuss foreign policy here.
I'll tell you real quick, as this match is going on and taking unfold right here, watch this, another high-res maneuver.
Oh, man. Oh, his neck hit the bottom of that step and bent over.
I'll tell
Mysterio
you what.
Jr.'s out of it.
Both men are hurt, look injured right there. I told you about high-res maneuvering, and that's what will happen. Both men out, maybe counted out. Rey Mysterio Jr., what a blow he took. Yes, internationally we are WCW. Door open. Come on in here. From all over. And we got great athletes here with the big boys play. But nobody tried to take over hostility until the outsiders came. And now we're standing up and saying, come on and bring it. Let's do this thing.
This is an organization with more than a century of history behind it. We are not backing down from a fight. 1-2 and almost a 3 in the Cruiserweight Champion. What a name Chavo Guerrero is making for himself early on in his career here in WCW. The whip. On the Cruiserweight Champ by back body drop.
Groom again earlier, a little look of frustration on the face of Chavo Guerrero Jr. here. He's been trying to beat Rey Mysterio, can't keep those shoulders down. Nailed him right there in the sternum, going again for the pin.
A beautiful drop kick.
Couldn't hold him down.
Indeed he couldn't, and Rey Mysterio Jr. Oh, so close to being defeated so many times in this match. Still to come here on the Pro, here on TBS. We'll take you back to a recent Monday Nitro. Highlights from Nitro as we get ready for tomorrow night. 1-2 and almost a 3 again by Guerrero. He's got to be frustrated. What is it going to take to pin Rey Mysterio Jr.?
Well, you see, he's hitting his hands down, definitely getting frustrated, but you can't get confused. I see right there his frustration led to confusion.
It's the hottest wrestling show on television on Monday nights, and it starts at 8 p.m. Eastern tomorrow night on our sister network, TNT, live from Palmetto, Florida. Live as always, beautiful reverse moonsault, hooks the leg, he's
I tell you what, that would have been a big victory right there for Guerrero Jr., Rey Mysterio Jr. It's so hard to put away, but once you got him, you got to go ahead and try to put him away right here. Flipped him over. Oh, going in for a roll-up.
The waist lock and Chavo hangs on.
No.
Line cross body block and smartly Mysterio just moves out of the way. He's going to roll him up. 1, 2, and 3. Beautiful.
He got him. Boy, Chavo Guerrero Jr., he's got to be upset. Talking about frustrations now. Left himself kind of wide open. I think knocked the wind out of himself when he missed Mysterio Jr.
Yeah, Mysterio Jr. sending a signal, Dusty, that he can wrestle on the mat as well as be the high flyer that he is known to be.
Well, I tell you what, Chavo Guerrero Jr. really had this thing in control up until the end of this thing. So this match will live to fight another day. I guarantee you we will see these two back at it.
This replay brought to you by Pep Boys, America's Auto Parts Superstore, our power pin of the week, Larry.
Well, that's a power pop of the week. Just hit that cement again. Right there, Chavo Guerrero Jr. out of breath, knocked the wind. High-risk maneuvers will take their toll on both men, but right here, interlaced the arm, then just brings it back, leg scissors it, puts the weight on his shoulders, Cruz.
Highlights from Nitro and a lot more when we continue on TBS here on the Pro in a moment. It was last week on WCW's Monday Nitro. An incredible alliance formed between the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, and Arn Anderson, and Sting and Lex Luger. We're all looking forward to Fall Brawl live from one of the most beautiful areas in the country, in the world, Winston-Salem, North Carolina.
Well, you may be looking forward to it. I know Steve McMichaels, Chris Benoit, they were apprehensive about the decision made by Flair and Anderson, even though they... backed it up, and they should. There's got to be some unity, got to be an end to the paranoia here in WCW. But let me tell you something. I've been in war games once, and there is not a king, there is not a sheik, there is not a shaw that's got enough money to get me back into another one.
Well, Dusty, you're the veteran of nearly 50 War Games matches. I think probably you feel the same way.
Yeah, but let me tell you something. You can look at my body and my head and my broken bones and everything and realize that War Games is the most vicious, most violent match ever put down. But if you want to get dues paid, if you want to get an ending to something, if you want to make a statement, that's the place to do it. That's why I believe that this pay-per-view really matches up as big as all of them, because bottom line, Sting went out on a limb on a lightning bolt
he
asked Flair and Iron to come in. Yeah, Mongo not happy,
right.
Benoit not happy, line, they gave in to the senior part of the hospital. So, what that matchup now looms to me is not only is Sting fighting the new world order, if you will, with Hulk Hogan trying his hostile takeover, but he also got to keep an eye out for Iron, Flair, and Luger. And Nick Patrick, he's refereeing. That's another guy in the new world order.
Well, paranoia.
Paranoia, that's true.
Why do you say paranoia, Larry?
Because that's his word for the week.
Yeah, but
there's no proof again.
Well, okay, maybe there's no proof, but who ever thought Hulk Hogan would do what he did?
Exactly.
Certainly we have a right, based on what happened with Hulk Hogan, to be concerned about everybody, to be concerned about Sting. What if Sting becomes one of the outsiders?
You have the right not to trust
anybody.
We'll
have this match, Sergeant Craig, the Pitbull Pitman, the DDP, and more talk about Fall Brawl and a whole lot more after this. Cruise along with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and the living legend, Larry Zbyszko. And it looks like Sergeant Craig the Pitbull Pitman suckered Diamond Dallas Page.
Yeah, well, you may fool Diamond Dallas once, but you're not going to fool him twice like that. Pitman may be smiling now, but don't underestimate Diamond Dallas Page. And again, there's Teddy Long trying to distract him. Diamond's going to have to keep an eye on the Godfather over there. And
you know, Pitman never used to smile. He never used to smile. Now
that's my point. Teddy Long has ruined this man.
That is not true. That is not so. Teddy Long has gotten this man to new and better height. Bottom line is, you're wrong about Teddy Long, the master of motivation. Dallas Page got problems with Craig Pittman right here on the main event. And our main event today on the Pro, on this Sunday evening right around. Let me tell you, big problem. Big problem are with the Guerrero family. I'm talking about Dallas Page. He got some Latino blood just a balling. And I guarantee you one thing, before it's said and done, Eddie Guerrero going to have his say with Diamond Dallas Page.
Indeed, that grudge match is scheduled. It's Chavo Guerrero Jr., nephew of Eddie Guerrero, against Diamond Dallas Page, the former Battle Bowl champion, the former Lord of the Ring. It's going to happen at Fall Brawl. And, of course, it's the NWO, the Outsiders, against World Championship Wrestling.
And, again, I think all the shrinks that Macho Man Randy Savage has seen in the past will all be put to void once the Giant gets his hand on him. And it will be done with Savage once and for all.
And for the first time ever, the Mexican Heavyweight Championship being defended on American soil. Hey, gentlemen, what a great time it has been here on this, the premier edition, the inaugural edition of WCW Pro on TBS on Sundays. We'll do it every Sunday at 5:05 p.m. Eastern. As we kick off the Destination Sunday series here from World Championship Wrestling at TBS. And look at the power move from Sergeant Craig the Pitbull Pitman. No hair to pull there. DDP, so there.
Well, Pitman reversed that. Pitman, a good wrestler, good mat wrestler, should concentrate on trying to get Diamond Dallas on the mat. But look at Page is thinking. He felt himself going down, hook that rope, let the referee do the work, break the hold, but to try to avoid getting on the mat with the Sarge. No matter how bad Teddy Long has softened him up.
Teddy Long has not softened him up. Teddy Long has done nothing but guide him to greater heights. And if he can get a victory over Dallas Page today, he will really be on the roll. I'm talking about Big Pitbull Pitman. Sting, Luger, partners. Think about this at home. Who are their partners for the World Game? Say it in your mind. Nature Boy Ric Flair and Arn Anderson on the same side.
There's no way that can work. There's no way.
What a pay-per-view that will be. The biggest of all.
What if one of the four outsiders, we're told there are four, maybe five outsiders, we only know three. Paul Nash.
Raymond Steele Jr. said there were four.
That's right, at least four.
But he was talking in Spanish, no one knows what he said.
I know what he said. What
Cuatro. Cuatro means four.
That's right. Cuatro. Or who, or what, or how many.
See, it means what.
No, it does not.
See, what Steele Jr. was saying is what happened to me.
Make your point.
Go ahead.
I just forgot it.
But there's a point right here. Pittman's in trouble.
What if one of the four, what if either Sting, Lex Luger, Ric Flair, or Arn Anderson, what if they're one of the outsiders? So there, that's my point. And it's not paranoia.
I don't think it's going to happen. Once they lock you into war games, those guys will have no choice but to stick together. And Diamond just stuck one to Pittman.
Diamond Dallas Page began life in World Championship Wrestling as a manager, decided he could do it just as well as anybody he managed in the ring, and so far has proven that. If you can keep up with Craig the Pitbull Pittman, you're doing something good.
You make no mistake about the talent of Diamond Dallas Page and the Diamond Cutter. I believe one of the most devastating, if not the most devastating, holes in WCW. Once he cracks it on you, he can put you out colder than a wedge, just like that.
Colder than a what?
Wedge.
Don't look at me. I don't know what he's saying.
You never heard that saying in Texas?
It's colder than a mackerel.
I hit that guy, and he was colder than a wedge.
Well, you're speaking Texas now.
Yeah. Well, you mackerel, you speaking Minnesotian.
Minnesotian?
Yeah, you lived up there for a while, Minnesotian.
I froze up there for a year, and I left.
Diamond Dallas Page. Had his feet on the rope. Lesson.
Hey, Dallas Page is really keeping this guy down. When you take a look at it, Larry, when you talked about Pittman being a great mad wrestler, Dallas Page is taking a playbook out of the lesson right here.
But what he's doing is he's turned the tide on Pittman. This is the position Pittman wants to be with Diamond Dallas Page on the mat. But instead, Diamond Dallas Page, he's got Pittman on the mat, and he's in control of the head again. Maybe that cancer that seeps into your mind called sportsmanship, infiltrated by the godfather Teddy Long, has softened Pittman up beyond repair.
Don't believe what Larry Zbyszko said. My children out there, all my kids around the country listening to all the little dreamettes, is when he said about sportsmanship, be a good sport. I want you to win, but be a good sport. Yes. Legend, don't do what the legend said.
Be a good sport. Lose with dignity and grace. And don't pay the bills, Jack.
Teddy Long is teaching Sergeant Craig the Pitbull Pittman intestinal fortitude.
The one thing Diamond Dallas has besides more professional experience than Pittman is, he's got a hunger. After being in the street, he'll do anything not to get sent back there. And Pittman will try, but look, he left an opening.
Oh, I forgot to ask, to thank you both for the flowers you sent in the hospital, and to thank you, I'm going to give both of you a big manly hug in just a minute.
I didn't send you no flowers.
Me neither.
Yes, you did. You just don't want a hug.
Well, Pittman may send the Diamond some flowers. He just nailed them right underneath the chin.
Don't forget.
He dumped them.
Tomorrow night, live on WCW Monday Nitro, 8 p.m. Eastern, 2 hours live from Palmetto, Florida. And look at this, Pittman. What power. And DDP almost goes over the top rope.
Well, Pittman got to put him away now. If you're going to be a winner at WCW with a big boy play, you got to know when to put him away. This is not, as you said, the NWO. Bah, humbug on the NWO.
Hollywood.
There's a contradiction in words.
There's Ken. Can't stand the sight of that man. What he has done to us is unbelievable. And now he's even taken our senior official, Nick Patrick, the man you see on the right-hand side of your screen.
That's no proof on that. But Pittman came close to throwing him over the top.
He's a referee, makes a good referee salary. He's got a mansion and Armani suits and a new car. What's the deal? What more proof do you
need? Maybe he got an inheritance or hit the lotto or something. You never
Speaking
know.
Of inheritance.
Who would play the lotto?
Slow down. Speaking of inheritance, did we ever find out who is...
He hit the pole!
Who was the benefactor of Dallas Page? Hard pole. Good pole. Pole cat. Did we ever find that out?
We didn't.
Who was the benefactor?
No.
I believe he's got him beat. I don't believe... Pittman's going to get in, Larry.
Well, I think right now Pittman is helpless.
Oh, Diamond Cutter on the floor.
He's out of it now. Talk about helpless and hopeless. Problem for Diamond Dallas is Pittman's heavy. He's going to have to get him back in the ring to pin him.
Somebody stop this man. This is wrong. Where is Nick Patrick? Didn't he see that? He's not going to count the three here. I can't. No.
Well, inside the ring he can.
One, two, three. That's it, and that's going to be it for this premiere edition of WCW Pro.
And an honest count
by Nick
Patrick. For the
legend, Larry Zbyszko. Yeah, right, the first time. And the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, I'm Cruz. We'll see you next week here on the Pro.